when I can't make a computer that doesn't freeze? How come I can't make a computer that turns into smoking a cigarette?
It's
don't a people turn into a bunch of gomers and start...
There's so many...
But all the Japanese tourists that come to visit smoke like chimneys.
And yeah.
You can't even walk anywhere on that island without getting bombarded by a smoke cloud.
Worse than Vegas?
That's just the cigarettes.
I would think it'd be bad in places like Tennessee, North Carolina, South Carolina, where the product is being manufactured. Because I was in Hawaii one time, and I don't remember it being that bad.
I just came back from there last week, and I just stayed in my hotel room the whole time. It was horrible.
Sounds like a fun vacation, Dave. Come on, it's not that bad.
It was that bad because the only tourists over there were from Japan. There was no American tourists.
Even snorkeling. The smoke was underwater. Thanks, Dave. I think
fish
you're a little emotional.
Around.
Yeah.
Sweeping generalizations there. All of them smoke.
Yeah. They just sat in my room.
All day.
Hey, Larry.
Yes, sir.
What's up, bud?
I was driving my truck back east, and I stopped off at this little mom-and-pop coffee shop. And I was sitting down having a cup of coffee and a piece of pie, and these old people come in.
What kind of pie did you have?
I had peach pie.
Back east, ice cream on the side. A cup of coffee and a slice of peach pie.
Yeah,
you just don't find that in California.
And they squatted down on the stools next
They squatted?
To me. And they just started sucking away on these cigarettes. And I go,
old people squatting is my new band.
I forgot I wasn't in Kansas. I was in Kansas. Squat on stools even.
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah, I know. Every time we go back to Chicago to visit family, we're always, oh, yeah, there's a smoking section. Forgot about that. The smoking section, by the way, is the restaurant.
Yes. I used to be so excited. That was my favorite thing about going back east, to hear the girls say, smoking or non-smoking, yippee. It was like my big thrill.
Why is it? Were you smoking at the time?
Yes, I was.
Ah.
And after years of living here, you can't smoke anywhere, to all of a sudden be able to get a choice.
I get excited about it, too, and I don't smoke. It's true.
You just want your clothes to smell that way.
You know, I just like... you know, extra freedoms, you know?
Yeah, I see.
It's like when you leave town and all of a sudden they're like, you know what? We're out of the big, busy town. Speed up a little bit. Let's go ahead and kick that speed limit up to 70, which really means 80.
80? Like from here to Phoenix. I love it.
Oh, man.
It's so fabulous.
Phoenix.
Remember when everybody used to smoke on airplanes?
Oh,
how bad that used to be?
Oh, ooh. I was one of the smokers.
Me too, but did you sit in the non-smoking section?
Oh, hell no. Because
the smoking section stunk.
No, you can't smoke. You couldn't smoke in the non-smoking.
Right,
section.
I just walked back there to smoke just because it was so it's hard to breathe.
No, I'd sit back there on purpose.
Emily, does that even register with you that not that long ago it was perfectly okay for you to smoke cigarettes on a plane?
You could.
Yeah.
Oh yeah.
All over the world.
In the back of the plane, you could light up. The back half of the plane was for smokers.
Never knew that.
You hear old DJs telling stories, too, of, you know, back in the old days, and they'd have this huge ashtray just completely full of butts.
Oh, my
God. They'd just
smoke
the whole show.
Remember your morning show partner at KDKB?
Both of them.
Oh, my God. That room was, like, blue. You walk in there, you could cut the air with a knife, and here's chainsaw.
That was a dream matchup.
It was a dream matchup.
Then I'd walk out past the newsroom, and there was Shelley Dunn puffing.
Oh, and he would be so pissed off.
I know.
You can't smoke in here. Yes, you can. No, you can't. Hit me in the stomach.
The Tracheotomy brothers teamed up with Huell Gibbons.
I know.
Yeah, I was the asshole in that equation.
Well, you were certainly outnumbered, and I felt bad for you, but not that bad.
That's true.
Who's this?
This is Callie.
Callie, what's going on?
You are, Dave. You're a douche.
Thank you.
Hey, I found a remedy for to quit smoking as I went to upstate New York growing up in San Diego. And you go up upstate and look into Denny's and bars and anything else up there.
Sure.
You ever try to eat eggs and have the guy next to you smoking a cigarette?
Sure.
Tastes really good.
Hell, I've eaten eggs with a smoke dangling out of my mouth before when I smoke.
Oh, that's my favorite, watching
it's
people
terrible.
Smoke and eat at the same time.
I know.
Get a cigarette in one hand, a fork in the other.
Mm-hmm. It's not a parody that goes together. The taste is awful.
Sure.
You actually taste... something that you never, ever could even stand, and it's your habit, too.
Ah, settle down, you wiener. Rub some dirt on it.
California babies.
Jeez. It's not that bad. You know, if you ever get a hankering for that, go to the casinos. There's a lot of that still going on there.
Oh, they smoke there?
Yes.
Oh, wow. Yeah. Sovereign nation, baby. Your rules do not apply here, white man.
Wow.
Yep.
And in Arizona, they can sell you the reservation cigarettes tax-free.
You can't do that here?
I've never seen it. Of course, I haven't been looking for
it. Sorry, go ahead, Chris Boyer. I got my ears on.
You can go online at a thing called BigIndian.com. Oh. For all your tax-free from the Seneca Nation.
You going to hurry up and say something funny today so we can get you off that microphone?
I'm not feeling inspired.
Oh.
Got to have a smoke.
I long for the good old days when a disc jockey could smoke cigarettes in his studio, play a record illegally, and get a free Buick out of it.
Absolutely.
And there'd be a big bag of cocaine waiting for him.
Damn it.
Those were the days.
That's what I got in the business for in the first place.
And look what happened.
And the hookers.
Oh, there were hookers?
I don't know. I'm just...
Oh.
There had to be.
You're customizing it now for yourself.
Wherever guns, free cars, and cocaine are, you'll find hookers. They're attracted to it like bugs to a light.
Suppose you're right.
All right, we'll do sports with the chainsaw next here. It's KGB San Diego.
It has a face, two hands, and very deep pockets. It's the Cash Clock on 101.5 KGB. Listen for it to wind up. Then we'll pay up when it stops. Be the 50th nationwide caller to 1-866-525-9467 to win cash.
$100,000.
Saquon and Nokia on San Diego's world-class rock. 101.5 KGB.
All right, Amanda, you're on the KGB. What's going on, girl?
I'm trying to find you in Temecula.
Are you there right now?
Yes, I'm driving through. I'm going to lovely downtown L.A. today.
Okay, here's what I want you to do. Have you got the radio turned down?
Yeah.
Okay, I want you to turn it to 10... You're in Temecula right now?
Yes.
Okay, turn it to 103.3 and turn the radio up good and loud.
All right.
Have you got it?
103.3.
Yeah, little thing called syndication.
Definitely got it.
All right, Amanda.
Thank you.
See it.
Oh.
Towelette for the chainsaw, please. Todd.
Hey, good morning.
How you doing, pal?
Fine.
Glad to hear it. What's on
your mind? Last night at Carl Berger Dodge.
You went to Carl Berger Dodge.
Yeah, Steve Boyer in that Dale Jarrett 88 car.
Right.
That was some testosterone there running around. Hey, ask Boyer how he liked racing. Did he have him learn how to run in turn four and hit the wall?
You're the one who's hitting the wall.
Boyer, did you and Todd have a little competition?
Right.
Yeah, go ahead. I got my ears on.
Yeah, I won the first one and he won the second one. So we passed a buck between us.
Ah, very nice. It's fun, isn't it, Todd?
Oh, it was great. We had a lot of fun.
All right.
It started to rain.
Oh, that's too bad. Thank you, Todd. Here's Bobby on to KGB. Bobby. What's up, Bobby?
Hey, man, I just wanted to know where I could get some tickets to go to the race this weekend.
What is that race this weekend, Chris Boyer?
Friday night, the KGB... Oh, excuse me, break.
Go ahead.
Friday night, the KGB Race of Champions. Your chance to come on out and see real NASCAR guys banging it up on the fastest 3/8 quarter mile paved oval in the West. We'll have tickets tomorrow at Fun Bike Center. Be there from 5 to 8. Mojo Nixon will have them today. And you can buy them at all Evans Tires locations if you want to pay the $20 a piece.
And what time does this big event begin?
Right around 5:30 or 6 o'clock.
And this is the same race that features the celebrity race between you and Bromo.
Yes, it does.
Where the loser has to present his loins to the winner bedecked in a thong.
That's the plan.
In front of the entire crowd, right?
Yes. I'm ready. Bring it on. That boy's going down.
Do you know what time the celebrity race is?
I think we start around 6 o'clock, Chainsaw, and that is the best that I have been given.
It's an entire evening of racing at Cajon Speedway.
Ah, awesome.
So there you go, Bobby.
Ah, thanks, man. Later.
And it's Friday, and then there's a race Saturday as well, but ours is the Friday night race of champions.
All right, excellent. Featuring real NASCAR drivers like Sterling...
Marlin.
Marlin. pretty cool. NASCAR comes to San Diego, kinda.
Part of it.
That's our. That's yeah. the way we're pushing it. NASCAR comes to San Diego, kinda.
Yeah. I think it sounds good.
All right, let's get a sports update with the chainsaw right now. I was watching the Padres last night and got to see Brian Lawrence set. Well, he tied a major league record.
Yes, he did.
Now, that's always good.
Oh, kinda for somebody.
Good morning.
Good morning, and thank you, David, and hello again, everybody. In the sports world, it was cold in Chicago yesterday. Padres announcer Jerry Coleman described how one of the umpires stayed warm.
The first base umpire, Gary Darling, has a dickie that goes up around his mouth.
What's your language in front of the lady, punk?
Wow, my dickie only comes up to the middle of my neck. Gary Darling must be a very exceptional man.
The first base umpire, Gary Darling, has a dickie that goes up around his mouth.
He is the man from Nantucket, David. In any event, Padres pitcher Brian Lawrence tied a major league record at Wrigley Field last night by hitting three batters in one inning and then gave up the bases-clearing double as the Cubs got away from the Padres and then got away further.
Here's the pitch. Drive left side, way back. How far? To the wall, near the wall. That ball is over the wall. Corey Patterson, a two-run shot, takes the game out of reach. It's now 7-2 Chicago. The first base umpire, Gary Darling, has a dickie that goes up around his mouth.
Cubs 7, Padres 2, Gary Darling. Well, I'm not going to attach a number there. The Padres have lost six in a row now, 7-13. They'll play the Cubs again today, 11:20 our time. For some reason, Tony Gwynn has decided to announce that 50% of his former Padre teammates took amphetamines when he played here.
Whoa.
In a story in the New York Times, Gwynn is quoted as saying that 50% of position players, non-pitchers, regularly use amphetamines. Bruce Bochy responded by saying, "I'd like to think if Tony thought there was a problem, he would have said something to me." New York Mets pitcher Tom Glavine, the National League player rep to the union, said, "I have a problem with all these guys that aren't playing anymore now coming out and saying that all these problems exist. If the problems were there and they were so prevalent, how come nobody said anything when they were playing?" Responded Gwynn, "Glavine's a union guy. I'm not a union guy. What are they going to do, hold back my pension?" Wow, Tony taking a stand now when it can't hurt him. You wonder what his motivations are. To stamp out amphetamines or smear half his former teammates without naming names. It's weird. Jerry Coleman, what's your take on it?
The first base umpire, Gary Darling, has a dickie that goes up around his mouth.
I have another shocking disclosure. 50% of umpires have dickies up around their mouth.
Oh, I know. God, brother. Now I've heard everything.
Me too.
So it makes it so hard to hear the call at the plate.
I know.
Can you speak up and can you get that dickie away from your mouth, darling?
Thank you, Bazooka Joe. The Yankees won again, clobbered the Angels 8-3. Yankees now 17-3. That continues to be the all-time best in their franchise history. Royals won again. They're 15-3. Flip side, Tigers lost again. Detroit now 1-17. 3-7 games, or 3-game sevens, I should say, in the NHL last night. The Wild cherried the Avalanche. The Canucks mistied the Blues, and the Flyers blew the Leafs. Those teams advance. Fresno has made the Taylor Cup final, so that Gulls will play the Falcons for the championship. Game 1, Friday at the arena. Game 2, Monday at the arena. Meanwhile, in the National Bank,
the 130 hitter, like the Vaqua, who couldn't hit water if he fell out of a boat. And I guarantee you this, when I pitched, and I was going to pitch against a team that had guys on it like the Vaqua, I sent a limousine to get the to make sure he was in the motherfucking lineup, because I kicked that his ass any day in a week. He's a motherfucking big mouth, I'll tell you that.
Basketball Association. Maybe the Lakers heard my prediction how they'd blow out Minnesota and got cocky. Last night in Minneapolis, the Timberwolves blew out the three-time world champions 119-91. Oh, sure, all-star Kevin Garnett scored 35 points with 20 rebounds. That's a fantastic performance. But who the heck is Troy Hudson? 37 points and 10 assists. Troy Hudson did this to the Lakers last night. Minnesota and Los Angeles are tied 1-1. Milwaukee talking New Jersey, that series tied 1-1 as well. And other sports, David.
You know, what you got to remember is out there in Chicago, that wind is coming in right off the lake, and it can get darn cold. And I don't know what those umpires are going to do to keep themselves warm.
The first base umpire, Gary Darling, has a dickie that goes up around his mouth.
Wow. Yeah, but how does he stay warm?
It is 6:35, 59 seconds. And this is your 101.5 KJB Sports Network.
Oh,
my.
I think he's doing it on purpose anymore.
Really?
I think he's got some age on him and he just doesn't care.
I don't care. God damn kid.
I don't think we're in a situation where there's so many generations past that language has been twisted to the point where he doesn't know what he's saying. Pretty sure he was in the Marines.
That's why we don't wear shorts around here. Did you ever see that Mark, what's his name with his pants off?
Oh, no. My
goodness, what a pair of legs.
What?
Whoa. And you know that umpire's got a nice squat to him. You know what? Even our baseball announcer wouldn't dare to say that the umpire has a dickie that goes up to his mouth. He might talk about a junior mint that's blossomed into an Eskimo pie, but he won't say the D word.
Nope.
He's boldly going where no broadcaster's gone before.
Right.
And I have to have a 60-second delay, please. Or a 6-second delay. Give me break. Huh?
What happened?
Well, come on. We have to watch what we say, but geez, what's going on over there in the broadcast booth at the Padres? All right, Chainsaw, thank you very much. It was brought to you by Express Tire, where all Cooper tires are on sale, and they must go. Call 1-888-EXP-TIRE. That's Express Tire. Here is Route 66.
Thank you so much. Got the usual bumper-to-bumper out of Escondido, southbound 15. Southbound 5 starting to bunch up around Poinsettia and again at Santa Fe. California Fresh Foster Farms chicken breast tastes best from Henry's Marketplace. Now through April 30th, enjoy Foster Farms boneless, skinless, tender chicken breast. Only $2.39 a pound. Value pack. Perfect for grilling and baking. Trust Henry's Marketplace for life. I'm Ruth 66 with Dave Shelley and Chainsaw, 101.5 KGB.
Where should you go? A local family-owned dealer or the one owned by a big corporation?
Go for the excellence. Come ham.
Hi, I'm Gina Cunningham from Cunningham BMW. At Cunningham, our family has given excellent customer service for over 40 years. We've developed thousands of long-lasting relationships. Since 1990, BMW measures customer satisfaction and gives its Center of Excellence Award to just 15 out of 350 dealers. Cunningham is the only San Diego dealership to win this award 9 times. You won't find us on the stock exchange. You will find us just off Interstate 8 at the El Cajon Boulevard exit.
Go for the excellence, Cunningham.
Get financing as low as 2.9% APR on new 325 coupes and 4 doors on approved credit through BMW Financial Services.
Go for the excellence, Cunningham.
Cunningham BMW.
Well, there is that new Eskimo fusion restaurant.
Walrus risotto again? I think not.
With the spring salad of Arctic mosses.
And the oh-so-predictable blubber tartare. I crave something more exciting.
The fatal table. All of their entrees are
potentially deadly. If I see blowfish sashimi again, I'll die.
Well, look at this.
Something?
Chevy's is introducing 3 new enchiladas.
How new?
There's a snow crab and shrimp enchilada in a habanero pesto sauce.
Ingenious.
Or the chipotle chicken enchilada, poblano peppers, a chipotle cream sauce.
Daring juxtaposition.
Or a spinach, mushroom, and artichoke heart enchilada.
Kel chic. All frightfully expensive, I hope.
Darling, this is Chevy's.
Well, I'll dress in your clothes, you'll dress in mine.
You twisted devil.
You still have that nurse's uniform?
Oh, yes.
For something truly nouvelle, try Chevy's 3 new enchiladas. And no, we haven't changed the chips and salsa. Chevy's. Fresh Mex.
Chevy's has 3 new enchiladas. Contents may be shocking. For a limited time only, Chevy's Fresh Mex.
I hated answering the phone. Those pushy high-interest credit card people were calling about our payments. Then I heard Ray Vinson on the radio. I called Home Equity Mortgage. Now I'm happy when the phone rings because it's my mom or my best friend, Sarah. Thanks, Ray.
You're welcome, Kathy. This is Ray Vinson, founder of Home Equity Mortgage. We help homeowners like Kathy save hundreds of dollars each month. Good folks with less than perfect credit come to Home Equity Mortgage to consolidate their high-interest credit card balances into one low-interest home loan with one low monthly payment. Home Equity Mortgage can help you get back in control of your money and your life, perfect or less than perfect credit. We treat you in a sensible and sensitive way. Call now, 619-284-9900. 619-284-9900.
Licensed by the Department of Corporations under the California Residential Mortgage Lending Act.
Brenda, hi.
Hi, Nancy. This is a little awkward, but can you come to my house and get your husband?
Tom?
He won't leave. Bill was telling him how our new Cox high-speed internet is so fast and so affordable.
Oh, dear.
And now Tom says he won't come home until you realize it's worth it to switch to Cox.
I'll get my coat.
Oh, bring a bolt cutter, too. He chained himself to the desk.
Do you feel this way about the internet in your home? You will with Cox high-speed internet. Get downloads up to 100 times faster than dial-up and an always-on internet connection so you never have to dial in. It's the best value in high speed.
Get Cox high-speed internet for as low as $29.95 per month. Call Cox for details. 1-866-658-0625 or visit coxsandiego.com today.
Limited time offer, purchase or rental of cable modem required. Actual speeds vary. Service may not be available in all areas. Other restrictions apply.
Cox Communications, your friend in the digital age.
But more than a store, it's the beauty of having just about anything installed, including flooring. The Home Depot at-home services makes it easier than ever. Imagine a group of hand-picked professional contractors who'll do your job the way you would if you could. They're installers with plenty of know-how, beautifully installing new flooring to your home. Tile, carpet, hardwoods, laminates, or vinyl. Whether you don't have the time or you're just not sure, at-home services will get your job done right away. At-home services is the start of a beautiful new floor, and it's the end of not knowing who to call or who to trust. It's professional installation guaranteed. Stop by the Home Depot now, and you can save 20% on all special order ceramic, porcelain, and natural stone tile. The Home Depot. You can do it. We can help. Offer valid through May 28th. Not valid on special order vinyl tile, any in-stock tile, or with any other offer. Installation not included. See associate for details.
Oh, aren't they beautiful,
Clyde? They sure are.
Red, yellow, white.
Camrys, Tundras, Tacomas, and more.
There's just rows and rows of
them. Oh, what a variety.
So many blossoms.
So many new Toyotas.
Clyde, I was talking about the Carlsbad flower fields. What are you looking at?
The huge selection of new Toyotas at Toyota Carlsbad.
I thought you brought me here to see the flowers.
I did, but $2.19 a month on new Camrys.
The flowers, Clyde, nature's poetry, the kiss of springtime on the earth.
So many Camrys with special lease of just $2.19 a month.
Butterflies floating on the breeze.
Me, test driving a new Camry.
The flower fields, Clyde.
Oh, I don't think they'll let us drive through the flower fields,
Peg. Are we going to walk through the ranunculus or what?
Right, a bountiful bouquet awaits us. We can tiptoe through new Toyotas.
Oh, Clyde.
Special Camry lease offer available on all models with MSRP of $20,469 in stock. $219 plus $16.97 tax per month on approved above average credit only. Not all buyers will qualify. Zero security deposit required. $19.99 due at lease signing. 15 cents per mile over 48,000 total miles. Camry LE sedan lease only. Offer ends April 30th. Toyota Carlsbad. I-5 Cannon Road, Car Country, Carlsbad.
It's today. Dave Shelley and Chainsaw's Hamill open at Steel Canyon is today. We tee them up. We hit them long. Because chicks dig a long ball. Brought to you by Barona Valley Ranch Resort. Looking forward to that this afternoon. That's unusual. That doesn't very often happen. Let me try it again. There we go. Thank you. Hey! Just calling to see how excited you are about today's golf game.
I'm really excited. I get to wear clothes for the first time.
You and me, buddy.
That's right. We're playing in the same group.
Do you know who we're playing with?
I have no clue.
I don't know who any of the people are who won the auctions.
I don't either.
They just have their, like, initials on there. I have no clue.
And this is a first for you to be able to get to play in real clothes.
That's right. This is our fourth golf tournament.
Yeah.
And all the other 3 years I've been wearing goofy stuff.
I know it.
But we got rained out last Thursday.
I know it. So there was no wager.
Yes.
Thus setting you free to play and
I have the bird. Just like my birdies will be flying today on the
What's
golf
that?
Course. I said, just like my birdies will be flying on the golf course.
Side bet?
No side bet. No.
Oh, okay. Hey, guess what we're going to do today?
What?
I know we normally do this on Friday, but I thought we'd do it today.
What's that?
A special Hamul Open Bromo Brain Bowl.
Fun.
Yay!
Well, we got questions about golf or something? Or
no, I don't. I actually have a special President's Edition of the Bromo Brain Bowl. Now, let me ask you something. If you're flipping around and you see a movie that you... What's your favorite movie?
Rudy's one of my favorite movies.
Rudy. If you're flipping around and you see Rudy on TV...
Right.
Are you going to watch it again?
Oh, yeah.
Even though you've seen it before?
Heck, yeah.
Even though you've already been down that road, you're going to see it again.
Yeah, in fact, I'm hoping that I catch it right from the very, very beginning.
Because it's so good, it's worth seeing over and over and over again.
Yeah, it's a great movie. It's a wonderful movie.
You know, I've been thinking about that exact behavior. I'm that way with The Godfather and many other things.
What are you getting at?
You know, I hear a song that I like, and I want to hear it over and over again. I see a TV show that I like, I want to see it over and over again.
Yep.
There's one thing that I could stand to see over again.
What's that?
Well, there's two things I could stand to see over again, actually, Chainsaw.
Yeah.
I could stand to see Abramowitz challenge his father in a Bromo Brain Bowl.
Oh, I think we could all see that.
That was great.
I would enjoy that.
Yes.
Be up for that, wouldn't you, Bromo?
Yeah. I'd be up for that, yeah.
I mean, I don't know how you are about this, but it's like you said, you know, you could see Rudy over and over again because it's entertainment. You and your dad going at it, mixing it up and matching wits is entertaining for us, and we could stand to enjoy it once
Absolutely.
More.
Yeah. Heck yeah.
Oh, okay, yeah. Whew. Yeah, all right.
And then if you weren't able to beat your dad,
right?
I could stand to see you wearing those little...
Whoa. Just for once, I get to wear clothes for once.
Stop it.
Those little pink hot pants.
Ew. I loved those.
And the porn star T-shirt.
Yes.
Yeah, have him wear it.
Oh.
All you got to do is beat your dad.
Is he crying?
Yes.
No, Ruthie, I'm not crying.
Oh, okay, I'm sorry.
I'm losing my mind.
Is that what that sound is?
Hey, maybe he won't be home.
It's something I could stand to do. How about you?
Hey, what if it's rained out? What if he's not home? What if he's not home?
Well, let me dial him up.
Why don't you win for a change?
He always goes to coffee early.
Well, let's see if he's home.
Don't be home.
Awful lot of numbers to dial 40 miles south.
No kidding.
Hello, WD.
Wait a minute, I know which one you are. You're,
You're Kelly. Wait a minute.
Dan.
Hmm? Well, very good sign.
Nobody
and this isn't.
Heard me. You reached WD, and at the moment I'm not home. Leave a message,
okay.
And I'll do my best to get back to you.
Okay, because that's a struggle for me to operate the telephone. Boning some brown gal right now as we speak.
Dad, you're not there, right? You're not there, right? Dad, you're not there?
Wayne!
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 It's Kelly and Dawn!
Hello!
Yeah.
Three guesses who this is.
Hey!
Dirk, Shirley, and Chainlink.
Hi, Wayne!
Wayne!
Well, thanks for calling.
Wayne, how you doing?
Well,
okay, that's good. How's everybody in Mexico today?
I'd like to say great, but not oh. Just short of a disaster, probably.
What's the matter?
Well, I'm maybe overestimated my skills in setting up a business. I've proved that I don't do that very well.
Well, let's give you a rest.
Now then, damn it!
I'll tell you what. Wayne, I'll do you a favor. I'll give your restaurant a nice, big, juicy plug, and then maybe you can do me a favor and take our little quiz for us this morning.
Oh, shoot.
No, come on. It'll be great.
No, you know what? I've had kind of a mental drain here.
These are easy questions. Easy ones.
This will stimulate you.
Yes, I know, but...
Rewrote a really easy question. What's the name of your restaurant down there, Wayne?
It's Jerusalem Restaurante Bistro.
Foldo Loco.
I know, he's tagged on it. Loco.
Foldo Loco.
El Foldo Loco.
Well, it's kind of an odd name, really.
And where is it located?
It's right across the border in the Rio area. There is a...
That narrows it down pretty good.
Just point your car south. You'll find it.
Right across the border, Dad. That narrows it down real good.
Well, you go across the border, and it's pretty close. It's thin, about a couple of miles of there. It's not too far in a pretty good area, actually. But
how about an address?
All right,
you go past the borough.
You have to call George the restaurant to get the address?
And it's what is it called again?
It's Bistro Restaurant, Bistro Jerusalem Restaurante. But Bistro and Restaurante basically mean the same thing. I never could quite explain why George put both of those on there, but he did.
Bistro Jerusalem Restaurante.
Right.
Okay. And this is in Tijuana.
In Tijuana.
And if you go in and you say, hey, I heard you talking about us on the radio, they'll hook you up with a nice meal down there.
We will. We will. And as a matter of fact, we'll probably grab you.
Oversell.
It was a bad time to open this restaurant here with the war and just a scare. For instance, I had an open house and I had about 50 people there, but I had none of my friends from the United States came because of we were really involved.
Why didn't you tell me? I would have been glad to be there.
I did invite all of you guys.
Oh, Bromo told me not to go.
Yeah, I did not.
He said, don't bother going to that.
I did not.
No, you, he probably, I sent an invitation to you guys. It was a time when they were thinking about, there was talk about closing the border, and I don't blame anyone for not coming down, but we didn't have. Right now.
All right, you ready to take the quiz?
We are naming, we're moving in, we're trying, if we can get enough money together.
Commit suicide right now.
To selling
got a rope.
Armenian
got a rope.
We're Armenian pastries. Bromo's Delights after my son.
What is it?
Bromo's Delights.
That's going to be a menu item?
No, that'll be an item that we will market in the United States.
Cool.
We're going to use our ovens here to...
Does it involve a cucumber and some Ready Whip?
No, it's really...
A hot dog and a thong.
Six different creams and...
really?
Okay, Wayne, are you ready to take the quiz?
No.
It's very short. I know you'll do well. Bromo, I have to put you in the isolation booth.
Did I agree to that?
Yes, you did a minute ago.
Yeah, you did.
Don't you get it,
it was a trade for your plug for your restaurant.
It's easy. You'll love it. It's so easy.
Tell me what topic we're on.
Presidents of the United States. Presidents of the United States.
Oh, shoot. Oh. I have my thing coming up here.
One minute?
The Roots Festival is the Adams Avenue Roots Festival again.
Listen, let me show you how easy this is. Here's the first question. Who gave the famous 4 score and 7 years ago speech at Gettysburg?
At Abraham Lincoln.
See how easy it is? You got one right already.
I just happened to click on that one.
Whose face is on the $10 bill?
Oh, shoot.
Whatever you do, don't pull one out of your
wallet. I'm going to go on a wild guess here and say Andrew Jackson.
What would-be president once claimed that he invented the Internet?
Gore.
That's correct. All right, next up. Aside from Johnson.
Am I doing okay?
You're doing awesome.
Kill him.
Aside from Johnson, who is the only other president ever to have been impeached?
Aside from Johnson, was Clinton.
What rogue president once drunkenly barked to his White House staff, this whole place sucks. That's right, it sucks.
What? Well, that sounds like, give me that line again.
What rogue president once drunkenly barked to his White House staff, this whole place sucks. That's right, it sucks.
Doesn't sound like Harry Truman, but let me see. It'd have to be a modern president to do that. I'd say Bill Clinton, okay.
All right, name someone who is not a president whose face appears on U.S. currency.
Oh, God. I plead the fifth on that one. I don't know.
Okay, what's the name of the wooded retreat that presidents use to get away from it all?
Camp David.
What U.S. president's signature is on the moon?
God. Wait a minute. Where do you get these questions?
I made them up last night.
I'm going to get my own quiz here.
What U.S. president's signature is on the moon?
Well, let me see. Would be... it would have to be.
Would it be George Washington?
George Washington.
Boy, what a dumb.
Don't worry about the time limit or anything.
Let's say Nixon.
All right. What president went by the nickname Old Creamy Thighs?
Well, I don't know, but I didn't vote for him, whoever it was.
What U.S. president took the opportunity to honk in the lap of a Japanese dignitary?
Honk, I don't know what honk means, is it?
Do I get any clues or any hints?
No, can't give you any hints, but you're doing good.
Give me that question once again.
What U.S. president took the opportunity to honk in the lap of a Japanese dignitary?
Well, it might have been. I'd have to wild guess Franklin Roosevelt.
Name two presidents, only two, whose likenesses are carved into Mount McKinley.
Two presidents?
Yes.
Washington and Abraham Lincoln.
What was President Eisenhower's job shortly before becoming president?
He was commander of NATO, but one of his jobs. He was the...
he's a hell of a guitar player.
No, I don't think he played a guitar. I think he was on the...
Interesting. What was the nickname often used to identify the wife of Lyndon Baines Johnson?
Lady Bird.
Who took over the office of president following Reagan's assassination?
What trick questions we have here. I don't think Reagan...
Come on, you can do it.
Come on.
You can do it.
Yeah, the General Haig.
General Haig, very good. All right, mark the time.
Do I get a find out how he did?
Yes, let's go through your answers, shall we?
Boy, for a guy who doesn't have a brain here, I did...
You did great.
You did awesome. First question, who gave the famous 4 score and 7 years ago speech at Gettysburg right away? You barked out Abe Lincoln, and that's correct.
Okay, I got this one.
Whose face is on the $10 bill? He said...
Jackson.
Ooh. I believe it's Hamilton, isn't it?
Mm-hmm. Oh, is it?
Yeah, I think Andy's on the 20.
I remember that because I'll probably ask that question 2 or 3 times again.
I think Jacko's on the 20. What would-be president once claimed that he invented the Internet? You said Al Gore, and that's correct. Aside from Johnson, who's the only other president ever to have been impeached? You said Clinton, and that's correct. What rogue president once drunkenly barked his White House staff, this whole place sucks? That's right, it sucks.
Who was that?
And you said...
He said Clinton as well.
He said Clinton, and it was actually Rodney Dangerfield in Caddyshack.
Oh, yeah, I know. Shoot, what a trick question.
Name someone who's not a president whose face appears on U.S. currency. I don't think we got an answer from you on that one.
Not a president.
Not a president.
Oh, I named the two presidents. I misheard that.
No, it's Ben Franklin. Ben Franklin's on the $100 bill, not a president.
Or Hamilton, yeah.
Okay.
What about Secretary
That's true. That's a good point.
Well, how did I do?
We're not done yet.
We're going through it.
What's the name of the Woodard retreat that presidents used to get away from it all? You said Camp David, and that's right.
Yay.
What U.S. president's signature is on the moon? You said Nixon. On a plaque put there by Apollo 11 astronauts.
Yeah.
What president went by the nickname Old Creamy Thighs? What did he say?
Probably Taft.
Taft? No, I'm sorry. It was none, actually.
He was a big boy.
A lot of people called Clinton that when he jogged around in those little short
Old Creamy
panties.
Thighs?
Yes.
Oh. What U.S. president took the opportunity to honk in the lap of a Japanese dignitary? You said...
Roosevelt.
No, it was George Bush.
The first George.
Oh.
Remember that?
I didn't think George did that.
Remember? We were all scared that Dan Quayle would be in charge.
Name two.
I've been enlightened here on this thing, really.
Now I'm learning.
Name two presidents whose likenesses are carved into Mount McKinley.
Washington, Lincoln, David.
Mount McKinley.
Yes.
I don't think there is anything. It's Mount Rushmore.
You should have
That's
said
correct,
that.
But you answered to Mount McKinley.
I'm not listening very well.
I know. Unusual for you.
Prep time. You didn't give me any prep time.
What was President Eisenhower's job shortly before becoming president? You said he was commander in Europe. That's correct. Lady Bird was Lyndon Baines Johnson's nickname. You got that right. And who took over the office of president following Reagan's assassination? You said Haig. Sadly, that's incorrect because the President Reagan was never assassinated.
No, attempted assassination.
Oh, I didn't say attempted.
Haig did say he was in charge, but I'm quite certain
that there's a big difference between attempted and actual assassination. For a grand total of how many right, Chris Boyer?
Who do I complain to on this on the?
How many did he get right?
Right, David.
Yeah, go ahead.
We have seven rights, David.
Seven right?
Oh, my God, that's an all-time high.
That's almost half.
Well, all-time high for me.
Nicely done, Wayne.
How did Dave do?
He hasn't taken the test yet.
Shoot.
Let me get him on the horn here.
What the hell is going on here? I should be slamming some round down right now. All right. I'm talking to these douchebags.
Hello?
Yeah, hello.
Hey!
What?
You ready to take on your pop?
Hi, Dave.
Hey, Dad. How'd you do?
I
did phenomenal, they say, but I did so-so, Dave.
He did better than he's ever done before.
Oh, I got the last quiz I did pretty well, the one you tangled me up in the cord and so forth.
He did better than
you've done before as well.
Bromo, he got seven.
Out of how many?
Almost half right.
Oh, so I have a chance then. Okay.
Oh, you've got a huge chance.
All right. David, be careful. There's some trick questions on there.
Have you told your dad exactly what happens if you aren't able to beat his score?
No, because all this stuff is happening.
No. Don't tell me.
Wayne, don't you want to know what's going to happen? Don't you want to know about the pink hot pants and the porn star t-shirt?
All right, I got to go.
All right, Dave.
This will be long.
Okay.
Okay.
Enjoy your coffee this morning.
Stand by, Bromo.
My name is Wayne, and I'm here to say that I really think my son is gay. He runs around town in a little thong. Always seems to have it on wrong. Live down south in a TJ town, cruising around for gals who are brown. The only bad thing about living down there, can't borrow Dave's underwear.
Dave,
you know, son of a bitch.
Are you gay, Dave?
I ain't got money. I ain't got fame. I got one thing. It's called the Wayne Train. Are you gay, Dave?
I'm gay.
All right, round two. For the pink hot pants and the porn star t-shirt.
Yay!
Which really is my favorite outfit of them all.
That's tradition. It's like the green jacket.
Yeah.
We've got to have it.
It's our green jacket. We wanted a green jacket, but we couldn't find one, so instead we found pink hot pants with a built-in package.
It's beautiful. It's one of the first signs of spring. It's like seeing a robin.
And this is a major tournament.
Yep.
Maybe we could have the tradition, just like the Masters. If anyone can actually be crappier than Abram was, he can give that person his pink hot pants.
Ooh, that's great.
I got a hunch he's holding on to him for a while. All right, let's get a traffic update, and then it's round two of the Bromo Brain Bowl for the pink panties and the porn star t-shirt next. Here's Route 66.
Thank you, Dave. Slow traffic southbound 5, North County Coastline, Santa Fe down to Manchester. South 15, Jam 78 via Rancho Parkway as you leave Escondido. In the East County, getting some slowing in La Mesa, West 8, Fletcher Parkway to Lake Murray. North 805 slowing in the South Bay from the 54 to Plaza. North 5 from the 54 up to Harbor. I'm Ruth 66 with Dave Shelley and Chainsaw on the 101.5 KJ.
Kearney Mesa Toyota wants to give you gas, so to speak. Through the end of April, come in, take a test drive at Kearney Mesa Toyota, and we'll give you a gas card worth $10. That's right, $10 of free gas just for taking a test drive at Kearney Mesa Toyota off 163 north of Balboa. Limit one card per family.
Have a good night's sleep on us. Mattress Discounter. Lay on it. Play on it.
Big during Mattress Discounter's special purchase sale. Save between 10% and 30% off selected top name brand mattresses, including Sealy Posturepedics and Simmons Beauty Rests. Thanks to Mattress Discounter's huge buying power, we've made a special purchase of some of our best-selling Simmons Beauty Rest and Sealy Posturepedic sets. For example, queen sets normally priced at $999 are now only $699. That's a $300 savings. You'll find similar savings on king sets as well. Don't miss Mattress Discounter's special purchase sale going on now.
Have a good night's sleep on us.
Got a passion for motorcycles? Yeah! Let your spring fever rage at Escondido Cycle Center with Kawasaki's all-new Ninja ZX636 Super Sport. Sleek wind tunnel styling and power that's been compared to the 750s. Vulcan Cruisers, more your kind of cure? Check out Escondido Cycle Center's special deals on a 2002 Kawasaki ZR1200. VIN number 018-860. Just $6,999. 2003 KX250s. ECC priced at $4,999. And a 2002 KX125. VIN number 031-207. Just $3,999. Plus, zero down interest and payments till January 2004 with your good credit on just about every Kawasaki in stock. So let your spring fever rage. Yeah! At Escondido Cycle Center. Nordahl exit just west of the 15. See ECC for complete program detail. Kawasaki, let the good times roll.
It's hard to put a value on a set of tires. Let me ask you this. Who rides in the car with you? Your kids, your family, your best friends? And how do you qualify the value for something as important as a human life? Well, at Evans Tire, they try. Evans Tire works very hard to make sure you get the safest tires at the lowest possible price. And during the month of April, you can get a tax savings up to $150 on Goodyear, Pirelli, Dunlop, or Falcon tires. Don't wait to get new tires. That's not smart. Stop by any Evans Tire's 13 convenient locations today.
And while you're saving up to $150 at Evans Tire, be sure to purchase your KGB NASCAR ticket for just $20 cash only. Tickets are on sale now. Watch Sterling Marlin, Ken Schrader, Kenny Wallace, and Jimmy Spencer battle it out at Cajon Speedway this Friday. For major brands like Michelin, BF Goodrich, Goodyear, Dunlop, and Pirelli, Evans Tire is your one-stop shop for tires, brakes, oil change, and alignment. Evans Tire, the store with the purple trim. Call 1-800-80-TIRES. That's 1-800-80-TIRES.
Police Department, this is Sergeant DiCarlo.
I'd like to report a stolen car.
When did this happen?
Just a few minutes ago.
From where?
The corner of Langley and Brookside.
You see anybody around the car?
Well, actually, I can describe the guy who took it.
All right, go ahead.
Well, he was about 6 feet tall, wearing jeans, a black jacket, and a blue baseball cap.
Mm-hmm, that'll help. Let me get the information on you and the car. Are you the registered owner?
Oh, no, I'm the thief.
The what?
I'm the thief. I just wanted to call and tell you where I'm going.
When your car has the new LoJack Early Warning Recovery System, whoever steals it may as well tell everyone what they're doing. Because with this new concept in vehicle security, you'll be alerted via phone, pager, and email if your car's being stolen. So you can notify the police, have LoJack activated, and get your car back quickly.
Okay, where are you now, sir?
Well, I'm about to get off the highway. Tell you what, I'll just pull over and flag you down. You can't miss me.
All right, see you soon.
You'll find LoJack Early Warning at automobile dealers. For a dealer near you, visit LoJack.com. LoJack. Keep it close.
Bugginator's home of the bigger, better bug zapper. Zaps everything within a 10-foot radius.
Yeah, this is Mitsubishi Motors calling, home of the bigger, better zero event.
Bigger, better zero?
That's right.
Buy a brand new 2003 Mitsubishi and get your choice. Pay zero down, zero interest payments, and zero car payments until 2004 and get $500 cash, or start your payments now and get even more cash.
More?
$2,500 on a new 2003 Eclipse RS, a Consumer's Digest Best Buy.
We need a deal like that. We just can't seem to keep people in the store.
No kidding.
Mitsubishi's Bigger Better Zero event. Buy a brand new 2003 Mitsubishi and make zero payments until 2004. Plus, get $500 cash back or start paying now and get even more back on select new 2003 Mitsubishis. Hurry, this deal ends April 30th. Important program and credit restrictions apply. $500 manufacturer rebate only available with 000 program. Other manufacturer rebates cannot be combined with 000 or any other MMCA financing program. Best Buy, registered trademark of Consumers Digest Communications, LLC. Used under license. Visit MitsubishiCars.com or call 1-888-MITSU-2003 for details.
Who the hell do you think you are? The DNC!
What the hell is that?
Dave Shelley and Chainsaw.
101 KGB.
Now this is exciting, isn't it?
Yes, it is.
Just like our green jacket.
Mm-hmm.
The little pink panties.
Oh.
Hey, I still have a chance. What happens if I win?
Well, then you don't have to do it.
Oh.
You sound disappointed. Huh?
How about if I win, Boyer has to wear it? Is he still on that microphone thing?
Yes and no.
What does that mean, yes and no, you douchebag?
Yes, I am on the microphone, and there's not a chance in hell I'm going to have anything to do with your bet payoff.
Hey, you don't have a decision in this. If Dave says that that's the case, then you have to wear it.
I'm not gay, damn it.
I've got all my clothes in my car.
I'm gay, damn it.
I'm not gay. I ironed my shirt, ready to go.
Your dad got 7.
So I and you said how many questions?
15.
All right, let me gear up my history.
Shut up!
Are you ready? Let's remind people what these pink panties are. They're little hot pants.
Oh, God, they're so cute.
And they have a little built-in holder for the package.
It's so adorable.
And last year, when he debuted these, he put them on backwards.
Well, that's a boy to do.
Why would you have done that?
Well, because if you wear it the correct way, your peckers... You're showing everybody your pink pecker.
That's what we wanted.
That's not what I wanted.
It's what we wanted.
So will you be wearing them backwards again?
I'm not gonna blow this thing.
All right.
Those pants have a poop tube. What the hell is it?
And it was so pathetic too, because it was, you know, poochy. It was
bad.
It was very bad.
And the tube top that says porn star on it.
Sweet.
All right, here we go. You ready?
All right, go ahead.
Who gave the famous 4 score and 7 years ago speech at Gettysburg?
Oh, I've heard this. It's Washington.
Whose face is on the $10 bill?
I get so few of those. Lincoln.
Hey, I forgot to ask. Is anyone betting money?
Oh, crap. No.
I'll bet 5 on Wayne.
Yeah, I'd have to bet on Wayne.
You're not going
to
find anyone to take that bet.
Of course not. 7 is just like...
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Well...
There's no way he can beat that.
Do you want to bet that he's going to get a certain number?
No.
We want to save our money for drinks.
We should bet that he's going to get none.
I'll bet $5 he gets one or more.
Ruth?
Okay, I'll take that bet.
All right.
Got to be a goose egg or I get money.
What would-be president once claimed that he invented the internet?
What would-be?
Would-be.
Which meant he was Bill Gates.
Who is he? Aside from Johnson, who is the only other president ever to have been impeached?
Nixon.
What rogue president once drunkenly barked to his White House staff, "This whole place sucks"?
What does rogue mean?
That's right, it sucks.
No, what does rogue mean? What does rogue mean? What do you mean, what rogue president? What does rogue mean?
Wild and crazy.
Oh, Lyndon Johnson.
Name someone who is not a president whose face appears on U.S. currency.
It's that dingbat chick on that $3 bill. What's that chick's name? You know what I'm talking about, right?
Dingbat chick?
I think that's her name. It's dingbat.
Are you answering or are you...
I don't know her name, but it's a chick on a...
Edith Bunker!
What's the name of the wooded retreat that presidents use to get away from it all?
One more time?
What's the name of the wooded retreat that presidents use to get away from it all?
It's Camp Marco.
What U.S. What U.S. president's signature is on the moon?
That's a trick question. No president's ever been in space.
What? What president went by the nickname Old Creamy Thighs?
That's easy. That's Clinton. Everyone, all the women Google over that clown.
What U.S. president took the opportunity to honk in the lap of a Japanese dignitary?
Roosevelt.
Name two presidents whose likenesses are carved into Mount McKinley.
One more time, I'm sorry.
Name just two of the presidents whose likenesses, their faces, are carved into Mount McKinley.
Well, there's four of them, I know that. McKinley and Grant.
What was President Eisenhower's job shortly before becoming president?
I think he was a banker, I don't know.
What was the nickname often used to identify the wife of Lyndon Baines Johnson?
I don't know, Mrs. Johnson.
Who took over the office of president following Reagan's assassination?
Who followed what?
Who took over the office of president following Reagan's assassination?
Reagan was never assassinated. He was shot at, but he never died. He was never assassinated.
Oh, yes.
Which last question. Which presidents were widely speculated to have frequently masticated right in the Oval Office?
None of them. They don't do that in the Oval Office.
Not even one?
None.
You're right. They say that for the Lincoln bedroom.
Or somewhere else. Or with Monica.
All right.
I don't do that in the Oval Office.
All right. Yeah. Let's go over your answers. Who gave the famous 4 score and 7 years ago speech at Gettysburg? You said?
Washington. You've asked me this before.
Lincoln. Yeah.
You got it wrong before,
Lincoln.
Too.
Close.
No.
Whose face is on the $10 bill?
Lincoln.
Hamilton.
Like I said, I see so few $10 bills, I wouldn't know.
Got some email here. DSC@101KGB.com.
Crackling rosy, get on board. We gonna ride till there ain't no more.
Bree wrote to me seeking my advice. Says, Dave, my husband and I were discussing music the other day, talking about people that we would not mind seeing in concert, and he and I do not always agree on music. Since I'm 8 years younger than him, I tend to listen to more of the current hits. But my taste does include a large variety. I have everything from Bach and Beethoven to Eminem in my CD rack. And, of course, we both listen to KGB. I'm pretty sure if we didn't agree on that, I'd have to divorce him. Anyway, my point is, he said that he would like to see Neil Diamond live. I'm pretty sure this makes him gay. I do not like Neil Diamond, so I told him if he was in concert here in San Diego, he would need to go with his other wife, because I definitely was not going. My husband says that Neil Diamond isn't like Barry Manilow.
Worse.
And he said he was not gay for liking Neil Diamond. I strongly disagree. Dave, can you please settle this for us?
Play it now, my baby.
If a man likes Neil Diamond, does that make him gay? Thanks, your loyal listener, Bree. It's too bad that a chick with a hot name like Bree,
I know,
is saddled with a Neil Diamond lover.
Yeah. I hate to hear about that.
Shell, your response.
Oh, he's gay.
He's gay!
He's incredibly gay, and he's hiding it from himself like so many men we work with here do.
Is Neil Diamond, does he have a big gay audience? Like, you know, like Diana Ross or something like that?
I really don't know if that's the case. I just know that he's not a cool guy.
He's not?
No. No. I would react the same way that Bree is reacting.
You'd be horrified.
I would be horrified, and I would be consulting some sort of clergy or
worried
divorce
about
attorney.
Worried about sexual preferences?
Yes, absolutely.
Tom, you're on the KGB. What's going on, buddy?
Hey, Dave, what's happening?
Talking to you, pal.
Neil is not gay. There's two types of people out there. There's people who like Neil and people who hate Neil. And
gay,
I like
and
Neil.
Straight.
Not gay. Romo's gay, but Neil's not.
You know what? You just don't know you're gay.
Oh, Shelly,
there's plenty of gay guys out there who just don't know it yet.
That's right.
Struggling with it.
See?
Whoops.
He had to hang up. The cord wouldn't stretch into the closet.
I don't know if it's gay, but it's definitely chick show.
Totally.
I mean, it's chick
and
show
old,
music.
Old chicks. You're talking 60 and over.
I'm telling you, you'd have been surprised when I was at the Barry Manilow show. Lots of hot young chicks running around.
Good God.
Here's Bree now here. Hi, Bree. How you doing, girl?
Hey, Dave. Good. How are you?
Good. Well, we're very sorry to hear that your husband is into the chick music.
That's so sad.
Thank you.
But I contend that all guys secretly harbor a secret fan base for some sort of chick music.
Is okay. that true?
Oh, really? Yeah. Yeah.
Well, we found out with you it's Barry Manilow.
That must explain it.
There's a lot of music by Barry Manilow that I actually like.
Mm-hmm.
What I also found out was I never, ever want to go to a Barry Manilow concert ever, 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 ever
like
again.
I didn't like the lap dance. I can't believe
I didn't
that.
Like anything
Aww.
Start to finish.
Aww.
None of it.
But you like the best of Barry Manilow CD I got you for Christmas
yep.
that year.
Yes, I do. Does that make me gay?
No. I think it does.
Halfway.
See, I think it makes me...
Pre-gay.
I think it makes me... a sad, humiliating man. But I don't think it makes me gay.
You're just a gay guy waiting for the right gay guy. That's what's happening.
Fine line.
See, I don't think so. And I know it's easy to say because I'm talking about myself. But this is what I was going to say about your husband here, Bree. I don't think it makes him gay. I just think it makes him a pitiful, cowardly figure of a man and someone that you should certainly be shameful of.
Absolutely.
Not to put too fine a point on it.
Is he right there in the car with you?
Yeah, he is.
Let me say hi to him.
Okay, hold on. It's Dave.
Hi, person.
Talk
okay,
to you like a person.
I'm not gay.
You are too.
You're so funny. Hi.
Hey, okay, what's wrong with Neil Diamond? It's nothing like Barry Manilow.
I'm not gay, damn it.
What about Tom Jones? Do you like him too?
Tom's a stud.
Tom is a stud, and, you know, my mother always...
Your mother?
My mother, yes.
But back in the day, women... women loved...
Very special relationship with Tom Jones.
A relationship?
Yes, absolutely.
You know, I think if you want to say it's corny or it's old-fashioned, I'd be in complete agreement with you, but it's not gay.
It's no, it's not gay. No, Bria, I'm sorry, what is your name, sir?
Rich.
Rich, I agree with you. Or do you call yourself Dick? No, of course not.
You know, Rich, when I said I wanted to go to a concert, I think I was being nostalgic. My dad listened to it while I was growing up, and
Richard, do not
among my top 10.
Rich, by making excuses, you make me start to think that you are gay.
Yeah.
I don't think listening to Neil Diamond is gay. I just think it's a chick show.
Well, I've never been, so I couldn't tell you, but I wouldn't mind.
You just have strong longings to go.
It's going to be you and a bunch right. of old ladies.
Yeah.
The old-timer's getting up there. I wouldn't like mind seeing them before.
How old are you, Rich?
I'm 33.
Yeah. Jeez. Well, I went to that Manilow show.
How'd that go?
Did you like it?
No, it was horrible.
Yeah, I wouldn't go either. But
it was absolutely horrible. Well, I hope the same thing doesn't happen to you with Neil Diamond.
It could be.
I don't mind hearing Manilow if it's on the radio or the CD or whatever like that, but being at the concert was just an absolute, utter nightmare.
Yeah. Well, you could be right, but I stand by. I still like his music.
There's nothing wrong with that. I don't think there's anything wrong with it. You're not gay, Rich. You just have an inkling towards the chick music. That's all. And that's okay. Right. I'm here to tell you. Hey, come on. I fall on the Manilow sword. No one's going to commit a bigger public suicide than that.
True.
I like some Sadaka.
Oh.
Uh-oh.
Well, I'm well known as a not-so-secret.
Power gay. That's right.
Aficionado of the power gay ballad.
You betcha. You
are James Taylor, Christopher Cross, Ambrosia, for crying out loud.
Oh, Ambrosia. Yeah. I love Ambrosia.
Hall & Oates. I mean, all that soft. I love that stuff.
Yes.
Air Supply?
No.
No
air supply is too gay for me.
I'm with you on the air supply.
I go for the quality power gay ballads.
Thank you, Rich.
Thank you.
All right. See you later. Too bad. There goes Rich with his hot wife. We just found out that he has several chick tendencies.
Stop it.
Sounded like they procreated at one point. The poor children finding out that daddy is, you know.
Wonder what he was thinking about that night.
Thinking about Neil's hair.
Right.
Yeah. Motivation, you know.
Get the job done. That's right.
That's a Will Ferrell.
Ooh, I'm with a woman. Ooh. Think of something else.
Does Will Ferrell do a Neil Diamond imitation?
Does he? I wouldn't be surprised. Here's Chris on a KGB. What's going on, Chris?
Hey, Dave.
Hey, man.
Well, we went. We talked when Barry was coming to town that we were both getting dragged. And did I not see you hand Barry a rose in the front row there at the concert, or is that somebody else?
No, that wasn't me.
Yeah, I think there's definitely a strong tendency towards desiring to go see these concerts, but I think you can hide under the fact that you were dragged to it.
Oh,
it's a little different than volunteering to go see Neil Diamond.
I'm not going to hide under anything. My wife wanted to go. If I didn't want to go, I would have put my foot down and not gone. There are plenty of things that my wife wants to do. Let's take a cruise to Mexico. Well, have fun.
Yeah.
Give it up, honey. Here, I'll give you some extra spending money. You know, there are some things that I just will not do.
Why don't you just get a bottle of water? You can get some.
I went.
Wasn't there a boy in college with whom you attended some sort of gay concert?
Yes.
Who ended up being a gay person?
Did we go to? Yeah, we went to the Manilow concert.
You
and me and
your person friend.
There were like four of us who went, and Mark definitely would. And we didn't know it at the time.
And one of the one of your boyfriends turned out to be a gay man.
Yeah.
So he was pre-gay at the time.
He was pre-gay.
I'm not sure what was going on there. I don't know if he knew he was gay at the time or...
But you didn't.
No, I had no clue.
Yeah.
I had no clue. I should be able to figure it out now. It's one of those things you look back and go, duh.
Now, do you have any clueness about your own gayness, David?
How so?
Are you pre-gay or not gay?
No, I'm not. I still like sex with chicks, Chainsaw.
Okay.
It's a good sign.
Specifically, my wife chick.
Right. Yeah. So you can't put a plural on that.
Yeah.
Trophy wife.
But I have been known to have had sex with other people previous to my trophy wife, my first wife, with the buttery chunks and a tremendous rack.
People?
Yeah. Women.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
All right, good.
Yeah, it happened, so...
Well, boy, you're still a douche.
I would like my record to speak for itself, and I have never had sex of any kind with any man.
Yet.
That's true. I have to include that.
So we're all pre-gay.
I'm also pre-operative, remember?
Oh. Yes, you are. Pre-operative transsexual.
Yeah.
Oh,
jeez. Well,
so troubling you, Chris? So are you, buddy.
Hey, well, I guess we all are pre-op in some form or another, but...
We're pre-dead.
Yeah.
See you later. Kevin, you're next. You're on the KGB. What's going on?
Hey, what's going on? I just want to say I got dragged to the Barry... Well, I got dragged to the Barry Manilow concert at Cox Arena Neil Diamond. A year ago?
Yeah.
At Cox Arena?
Yeah.
My girlfriend wrote for City Beat, and so we got tickets, so I wasn't... I didn't pay for tickets. If I would have paid for tickets, I think that would have qualified me as gay.
I'll tell you what, knowing what I know now, if I had to go to a Manilow or a Neil Diamond concert, I'd be going to Neil Diamond.
Yeah.
Well, I mean, did you see the movie Saving Silverman?
Yeah.
See, now there, he was
funny.
Gay in there.
He was funny in that movie.
Yeah.
Yeah. You ever seen that movie?
Oh. No, I haven't.
It was pretty good. Neil Diamond ends up being like an action hero in the thing. Oh,
I respect Neil Diamond. His body of work is tremendous, and he gets up there and he sings.
It's chick music.
It is chick music. He did I'm a Believer, of course, that the Monkees made famous, and then Smash Mouth covered.
I was going to say, I think everybody's a closet Neil Diamond fan in some way, whether or not they don't know that they like his music.
No.
Shelley, not a Neil Diamond fan? No.
I'm not a Neil Diamond fan, but I respect him.
There's a song out there that somebody else is. He's written so many songs for so many different bands. You probably don't even know you're listening to Neil Diamond.
And I saw a concert on television, and he still gives out that professional effort. He is not shortchanging anybody in concert.
Christine is on the KGB here. What's up, girl?
Hey, how you doing?
Good. How are you?
You know, I hang out with many gay men, and I go to a lot of gay men nightclubs. And not once have I ever heard a Barely Man Enough song or Neil Diamond or anything like that. It's always Donna Summer, it's Cher, it's Madonna.
Oh, it's clubs, yeah.
You know?
Yeah, the clubs, those guys like the real glam chicks.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But nobody's ever admitted to me liking Barely Man Enough.
I think he's a gay man whose music appeals to women.
I've looked through the record collection, and I've never seen anything like that, so he's not really gay.
Who isn't gay?
Barely Man Enough or
he's gay.
Diamond.
He's gay.
He's not gay, he's just a...
No, he's gay.
Women.
He's a pole smoker.
But he's definitely not gay, but he's there aren't men either. But.
He's gay.
How do you know?
He knows it. His boyfriend said so.
He's gay.
Gay.
All right. Thank you.
And my boyfriend, he's a DJ, and he's not gay because he doesn't have any of those albums. So.
Where does he DJ?
He DJs at MCRD.
Okay, cool.
In fact, today's his birthday. Happy birthday, honey. I love you.
Is he a fighting hero of the armed forces?
Hmm?
Fighting from the turntables.
Fighting DJ.
Yes, fighting DJs.
Woohoo!
All right, thanks a lot, Christine.
Thanks a lot.
See you.
Bye-bye.
This brings an opportunity for the ladies to call. 888-570-1015 and rat out your husband.
Yes.
And tell us what chick or gay singer he specifically likes but is afraid to tell.
Excellent.
And then we'll call him. We'll ask him what his favorite song is. And when he says, this is Metallica,
Back in Black.
We'll say, really? Isn't it Mandy by Barry Manilow? 888-570-1015 is our number if you want to rat your man out. Wouldn't you want to? We'll get you on the radio next year. The KGB San Diego, KGBB Temecula.
Here's news I never thought I'd have the opportunity to bring to homeowners. Effective immediately, Home Equity Mortgage is now offering an unheard-of new low 4.5% interest rate. Hi, this is Ray Vinson, founder of Home Equity Mortgage. Our new lowest ever 4.5% interest rate is good news for homeowners, especially now when you're worrying about those high-interest credit card bills or stressing out about saving money. Only Home Equity Mortgage is offering 4.5% interest rates, and only Home Equity Mortgage treats you in a sensitive and sensible way, whether you have perfect or less than perfect credit. Our all-time low 4.5% rate won't last forever, so call Home Equity Mortgage immediately.
Home Equity Mortgage, the future belongs to you.
At 4.5%, you can save even more money. Call now, 284-9900. That's 619-284-9900.
Licensed by the Department of Corporations under the California Residential Mortgage Lending Act. APR 5.223. Rate subject to change.
Kearney Mesa Ford's doing it again with your choice of towering savings. That's right, your choice. Every Explorer four-door in stock, 4x2 or 4x4, doesn't matter. Get 7,000 net savings, every one. 7,000 net savings. Or how about F-150 Super Cabs? 7,000 net savings. And not just on one or two, my friend. We're talking every one, 7,000 net savings. With Kearney Mesa Ford's huge inventory, you're choosing from over 800 available new and Ford-certified pre-owned trucks, SUVs, cars, and vans. Take advantage of 0% APR financing on approved credit on just about every new Ford available. Not low rates. We're talking no rates at 0%. And if we make a deal, we'll pay off your trade no matter what you owe. Just look for the tower between the 805 and 163 freeways at 7303 Claremont Mesa Boulevard. Just minutes from anywhere, it's Kearney Mesa Ford.
Kearney Mesa Ford, your tower of savings.
Savings include 4,000 KMF discount from MSRP and factory rebates of 3,000 in Louisville OPR option. Sale ends Sunday.
The San Diego Unified School District cuts $52 million from the budget and 400 administrative jobs. And the military homecomings are underway in San Diego. Get the latest news 24 hours a day on News Radio 600 KOGO.
Actor Kristen Davis using a typical cell phone.
Excuse me, where's the set for the morning show? I'm supposed to be on in 15 minutes.
Sorry, I don't know, they moved it.
Oh, I can check with my publicist.
Hello, this is Rebecca. Leave a message and I'll get back to you as soon as I can.
I'll just find it myself.
Oh, must be the next one.
That's interesting, but what happened after you married your nephew?
Definitely not.
Well, that was fun. Wonder what would have happened if Kristen had been using a Nextel with the walkie-talkie feature.
Hey, Rebecca, where's the morning show?
It's the last lot on the left.
Yes, life's good when you're Kristen Davis. But life's better when you're Kristen Davis and you have the cell phone with a walkie-talkie. Nextel. For more information, call 1-800-NEXTEL-9 or shop at Nextel.com. Make your cell minutes last longer. Sign up for a Nextel free incoming calling plan today. Offer ends April 30th, 2003. Shop at Nextel.com or call 1-800-NEXTEL-9. One-year agreement, account settings may apply. Phones by Motorola.
We've laid the foundation and raised the wall straight and tall for all those American dreams. The Golden Gate and the Hoover Dam, we were there to help with brick and beams. Yeah. Under the sun, Shea Holmes, Shea Holmes, caring since 1881, Shea Holmes.
Buying a new home is the largest purchase decision of your life. So educate yourself online at Shea-Homes.com. Only Shea Homes offers so many services designed to complete the home buying experience. Programs like Shea University, Shea Advantage, and Shea Mortgage. Visit them at Shea-Homes.com.
Caring since 1881. Shea Homes, Shea Homes.
When your morning grind is in your transmission and not in the coffee cup, it's time to see AAMCO. When you feel like a shiftless bastard, it's time to see AAMCO, the transmission experts. AAMCO Transmissions is the home of the low-priced Safeguard flush and filter change, and it may help you with that shuddering transmission. Besides, it's just probably a good idea to get that old fluid out of there before the summer towing season arrives. AAMCO Transmission Specialists will give your powertrain a look at no charge because they offer free external diagnostics. AAMCO knows transmissions, from the latest electronic models to classics and hot rods. Nothing is too old or too new for my friends at AAMCO. They have 40 years in the business, and there are 20 million AAMCO transmissions running the road today. They employ certified transmission experts, and I met with the folks at AAMCO. It's where I send my friends. AAMCO Transmission Centers, they'll honor most extended vehicle warranties, and when you leave AAMCO, no matter where life takes you, you'll go anywhere in the contiguous 48 United States with the best AAMCO warranty in the business, honored coast to coast. Car, truck, van, or SUV, manual or automatic, for a job done right at a price that's right, call 800-GO-AA-MCO.
It's KGB. You're with Dave, Shelley, and Chainsaw. Here's Karen on the show. Karen, how you doing, girl?
I'm good. How are you, Dave?
Good. What do you think of my take so far on Neil Diamond?
I'm not a real big Neil Diamond fan, but I think you're right. I don't think it's necessarily gay.
It's chick music.
It is.
But it's not gay.
But I don't like it.
So. Do you have something like this going on in your house with your husband?
Oh, it's terrible, Dave.
Okay, why? Who's he like?
Air Supply.
Oh.
I know.
You didn't know that before you married him, did you?
Actually, I did, Shelley, but, you know, he's really manly, but he's just got this quirk.
Yeah, gay quirk.
Were you knocked up or something? I mean, did you have to go through with it?
No, I wasn't. I don't know what I was thinking.
Anybody else besides Air Supply?
Actually, it gets worse, I think.
Okay.
Do you know who Rick Astley is?
Oh, God.
He likes Rick Astley?
Oh, no.
Oh, my God.
He likes Rick Astley.
He does.
Oh, that's a pity. All right. Let's get him on the horn. Hang on a second here.
Okay.
Don't say anything. Okay, what's his name?
Brand. B-R-A-N-D.
Okay. We're no strangers to love. Oh, yeah. Do you know this song?
No, but I can tell right away what a problem this would be in my relationship.
Lucky, lucky, lucky you.
The person you are calling does not take unidentified calls. Your caller ID was blocked. To temporarily unblock your caller ID and complete just this call, press 0 to enter an access. Please hold while we complete your call.
Oh, now I know this.
Hope he's not in the shower.
Yeah, hi. Oh, sorry. We've known each other. Tricking over to voicemail.
Hi, you reached the Bogard residence, and we're not home right now to take your call, but please leave us a message, and we'll call you back.
What's that?
He's not going to pick up.
Yep. Well, I'm sorry about that. Rick Astley, that's a toughie.
Yeah.
It is really bad, but, you know, what can I say?
Your husband's gay. That's what you can say. Thank you, Karen.
Thank you. Bye.
See you. Who's on the warm line?
Allie.
Oh. She's going to rat me out for something now.
Uh-oh.
Dad, you like Rick Astley, too. Hey, kiddo.
Hi, Daddy.
What's going on, honey?
I wanted to ask you if I could go to work with you.
If you want, okay, is that tomorrow?
Yeah.
Okay, you know how early you got to get up, though, right?
Yes.
It's still dark out.
Yeah, it's going to be bad. I mean, it's bad. It's early. I'll try waking you up, and if you want to go, you can come in, okay?
Okay.
Is this something that the school is doing?
Yeah.
Okay. Are the kids going to go to work with their dad, too?
I don't know.
Oh, okay. Don't really care, huh?
No.
What do you want to do when you're here?
I don't know.
Because do you know what your dad... If someone comes up to you and says, Allie, what does your dad do? What kind of work does he do? What do you say?
don't know.
Because you know what this is about, right, honey? This is so that you can. The reason.
It's easy to push all those buttons.
You want to press a button?
That's okay. What he does for a living.
Yeah,
that's what you do,
honey.
Yeah.
What? If pretend I'm someone else, okay? I'm just like a friend of yours at school, and I say, "Hey, Allie, what does your dad do?" Well, how do you answer that?
Talk.
That's right.
Well, what do you mean talk? Where does he talk?
At the radio.
Oh, he talks at the radio. Is that a hard job?
No.
Is it an easy job?
Yes.
Can anybody do it?
Yes.
Could a monkey do it?
Wait a minute. Could a monkey do it?
Could a monkey do it?
Monkeys can't talk.
Allie, I don't think a monkey could do it, could he? Yeah. Well, that's what this is for. I think this is a good thing, actually. This is so that kids can come and learn about what their parents are doing all day. To pay for their Roxy pants and their bread and their food and their
Barbies.
Extra phone and their computer.
All right. Sorry. Easy.
What's that, honey? Who are you whispering to?
Mommy.
Al?
Uh-huh. Your mommy in the background.
Anybody can do it.
Anyone can do it. Yeah, I heard you the first time. All right. Yeah, if you can wake up in the morning, you can go, okay?
Okay.
But it's a toughie. Okay. Can I talk to Mom?
Yeah.
This will be good.
Hello?
Hey.
Hi, honey.
Will you help me get her up in the morning?
Sure.
Because, I mean, I can, you know, I can wake her up and all that stuff, but I can't, like, put ponytails in her and stuff like that.
Oh, yes, you can.
No, I can't.
Sure you can.
Honey, I've tried it. The poor kid looks like Pebbles or something. I don't know. It's terrible.
Pebbles is cute.
Bad.
Yeah, no, I'll get up with you and get her ready.
Okay, cool.
And then, but you have golf. Where are you golfing tomorrow?
Way, 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 way down there.
Oh, boy.
Yeah, so okay. you're gonna have to come and get her, okay?
Oh, okay. All right, I can do that. She's all excited.
Okay, that's cool.
All right.
How's everything there on the homestead?
Oh, just getting ready to go down to take him to school.
Very good.
How's everything there?
Pretty good.
Yeah?
Going golfing today.
I know, and tomorrow.
Going golfing tomorrow. This is pretty good.
I might need to get out there and do a jig outside.
Might be spending a lot of time away from the house for a while.
Yeah, I bet you're going to hate that.
This is pretty good.
Hon.
Huh.
That's not nice.
Oh, okay.
You sent me a nice email.
Yes, I did.
See?
Yep.
Thank you.
I'm always thinking of
you.
Was
it nice or was it dirty?
No, I just said, have fun today. I'll miss you. And then he wrote back.
What did he write?
I'll be thinking of nothing but you.
That was sweet.
And his cigars and his martinis.
Right.
I thought about writing that, but I thought it would hurt your feelings.
She knows you.
Oh, honey, you're cute.
All right, Toots.
I'll miss you.
I'll miss you, too.
Okay, I'll see you soon.
All right.
Bye.
Bye, honey. Here's Angie on the KGB. What's going on, Angie?
Hey, how you guys doing?
Good. You calling to tell me about some kind of upsetting music that your husband likes?
Well, it's not really that upsetting, but I've been threatening to call and put him on the show for a while. So
yeah.
Like, get enough time to do it.
Yeah, okay.
He likes Alanis Morissette.
Chick music.
Yeah, it is.
Bitter chick music.
Yeah, it is rock.
It's a lot better than rock. He's a rock and roll kind of guy.
You know what? Some of it's pretty lame.
Well, I guess we always think of that angry, angry song, but she does have some real wimpy kind of.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, you're right. You're right.
Does he like all of her music?
I don't know. He had the CD, so I guess.
Ugh. I mean, there's a lot. Let me see. Like this one. Hey, hey, hey. Okay, that's gay.
Jesus.
I don't know if he likes that or not.
Uh-huh. let's see. Taking a while to load up here. I don't know. I'm half and half on Alanis Morissette. A lot of the stuff she does I like, but...
I like it too.
Yeah, she's mostly just popular music.
Yeah,
you know?
I wouldn't put that necessarily into a bad category.
Yeah.
It's chick music for sure, but it's not Rick Astley or Air Supply.
Yeah.
No, you got me on that one, though.
Yeah, I think we give him a pass on this one, Angie. Okay.
All right, no problem.
All right, see you later.
Bye.
What's worse, Rick Astley or Air Supply? If you have to be known as a fan of Rick Astley or Air Supply, which way are you going, Chain? So it's an easy pick for me.
Air Supply.
Yeah, me too.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I mean, it's a horrible
choice. Because they have a
ability. And they have a bill, and they were...
What? What?
Air Supply.
Yeah, but that was...
But Rick Astley is just totally. No way.
Well, he's flamer gay disco boy.
Come on. My God, that's all you hear when you pass by the brass rail. You do. They have the windows open and that song playing. I just didn't know who it was.
What's the brass rail?
Stop it. It's where they push in your stool. In
the press. I thought that was Queer Mary's.
No, Hamburger Mary's.
I think Lost in Love was the big Air Supply song, right?
Well, it's one of them, but you know, if you listen to it, there's actually some ability there. This would definitely be on KPRS.
You're so funny.
Music for persons.
Stop it.
I like this song. I like this song. I'll see.
Oh, thank you.
Can't help it.
You know what? For its time.
It's because I'm gay.
But for its time, I don't think it was as gay as we think it is today. And it's not nearly as gay as that other song.
Rick Astley?
Yes. That is
I like that
pretty
one.
Close.
I like that one much better.
It's
at least it has
close.
A beat.
That might be a photo finish. It's pretty gay.
I think it's Rick by a nose.
Huh.
Just a little bit gayer.
Yeah, definitely. No question about it, because that's a chick singer.
No, it's not.
Are you kidding me?
Air Supply is two guys.
It's two guys?
Yeah.
Oh, for crying.
Hey, Chainsaw. That chick that sings lead for Culture Club, that's a guy. Air Supply was two guys, buddy.
Whoa.
Neil Sedaka, that's a guy.
Now that's a chick.
Oh, no,
James Taylor, that's a chick.
Oh, come on.
Yeah.
James is cool.
Always excellent musician.
For a chick.
Absolutely.
Didn't you always think Neil Sedaka was a woman, though? Weren't you shocked when you heard it was a guy?
Absolutely, you're right.
It can't be a guy.
I know.
I thought for sure, in the very beginning when Culture Club first came out, I thought for sure that Boy George was just this whacked out chick.
Right.
Like for a good couple of weeks. I thought, man, that's a weird looking chick.
Wow.
Yeah.
Wow.
And Neil Sedaka sounds like Carly Simon.
Yes, that's what I thought.
All right, it's KGB. Let's get a traffic update. Here's Route 66.
Thank you so much, Dave. Southbound 5 working with a wreck approaching Santa Fe Drive. Semi conked out in the middle of the freeway. Has it backed up to Lucadia. Then some slowing down past that as well. Slowing on the northbound side of 5 where there's a crash approaching Sereno Valley. 3 cars on the right shoulder and a truck on top of a car. Got to have some looky-loo slow down to take a peek at that. Slow traffic westbound 94 out of the East County Sweetwater Springs to the metering ramps. Westbound 52 slows from Mast up over the hill. Southbound 15 slows in Escondido and then again at Mira Mesa. North 5 slows from the 54 to Harbor, while North 805, 54 to Plaza, then Balboa to the 52. Discover great outlet shopping at Carlsbad Company stores. Enjoy the Festival of Flowers and spectacular spring display created by KCR Rock. For details, visit carlsbadcompanystores.com. I'm Ruth 66 with DSC 101.5 KGB.
It's something we all wanted more of. Until now. Because the cash clock is on 101.5 KGB. And when it winds down, we pay up. And you win cash. $100,000. Just keep it locked to KGB. So you can be the 50th nationwide caller to 1-866-525-9467. From Saquon in Nokia. On San Diego's world-class rock. 101.5 KGB.
The Cash Clock is brought to you by Nokia. Put your favorite song on your favorite phone. Buy a Nokia ringtone card at participating 7-Eleven stores today.
The Home Depot is more than a store. It's inspiration to create the lawn and garden wonderland you want. Right now, get everything you need to make your yard your pride and joy. The Home Depot has plants from all the best growers. Begonias to exotic orchids. Climbing vines to ground cover. We also have our one-year plant guarantee, so the color of your thumb will never come into play. Get the power to mow, blow, edge, and trim with the most dependable names in outdoor power tools. Powerful stuff like John Deere, Toro, Honda, and Echo. The right tools, the right accessories, the right one for you. And let our experienced associates answer all your questions to help you figure out what or how much you'll need to make your yard look spectacular. The Home Depot is the guaranteed low price every day to make every dollar work. We're more than a store. We're where your lawn and garden dreams become your lawn and garden reality. The Home Depot. You can do it. We can help.
Hey, do you know about M-Mode? It's the service from AT&T Wireless that lets you send pictures to people. Pictures on your wireless phone. Send all your friends pictures of anything, like your new puppy.
Your new boyfriend.
The cop who pulled you over. Your new tattoo.
Yikes.
The shoes you're mildly interested in buying but aren't quite sure about. Yes, it's M-Mode. Send pictures, check email, listen to music.
That's M-Life, your mobile life made better by AT&T Wireless. Hurry into an AT&T Wireless store or visit attwireless.com/M-Mode.
Limited time offer, credit approval, and active voice plan required. Geographic limitations, device compatibility, and other monthly charges and restrictions apply.
Barbecue, it's the place for you. Friends, get a head start on the barbecuing season with the perfect grill at the absolute best price where... at Barbecues Galore. Right now, get an amazing deal on the top-of-the-line 38-inch Grand Turbo Stainless Steel Grill. This powerful 62,000 BTU grill comes loaded with accessories like a stainless steel rotisserie, rear burner, and a pull-out gas cylinder shelf. You won't beat the quality or the price anywhere. Friends, Barbecues Galore carries the largest selection of barbecues and accessories, all at the guaranteed lowest prices. For all your barbecue needs at the guaranteed lowest prices, remember, shop Barbecues Galore. Now, four stores in San Diego. For the nearest store, visit the website, bbqgalore.com, or call 1-800-GRILL-UP.
If you've been going from dealership to dealership, maybe you've heard the same old story. Gee, I'm sorry, you owe too much in your vehicle or the credit. Sorry, we just can't make it happen. What should they do, Gary?
Tom, you got to come to the Giant Pearson Ford. Right now, it's one of our biggest sales ever.
And I mean, it's incredible. Not one or two, but everyone in stock. You're going to talk about the hot-selling Ford F-Series, the F-150 four-door super cab.
We have a phenomenal selection, Tom. Hundreds of trucks in stock. Right now, you can save over $8,000 and you pick it out.
What?
You know it. Everyone with a total before discount of $26,935. That means, Tom, this truck's automatic, XLT, deep bucket seats, power windows, locks. It's incredible. Take a $490 factory discount, $26,445 MSRP, $46,45 deep Pearson Ford discount, $21,800 sale price, $3,000 factory cash back, $18,800 your net cost, and you pick it out.
The total before discount is almost $27,000, and what's the price right now?
Just $18,800, lease or buy, and you pick it out.
You better head straight to the Giant.
Pearson Ford, Dillon's 55.
See Pearson Ford, they stand alone at Fairmont and El Cajon.
All right, Charlie, you're on the KGB.
Morning, Dave. How you doing, buddy?
Tip-top. Talk to me, Cuckoo.
Love your show, but you're so wrong on JT.
Wow, what did I say that's so wrong?
James Taylor, he ain't gay.
I never said he was.
You guys have been talking about him like power gay ballads for a while now.
Well, he is that, but he's not gay. But he's chick music for sure.
I'd call it more like relaxed kind of... down home country.
Yeah, that's chick music.
Kind of stuff.
Yeah, it's chick music. Charlie, there's nothing wrong with it.
He's got tunes about, like, you know, one night stands and stuff like that.
And shooting heroines.
The old days.
Yeah. Well, I'm sure it was chick heroin that he was shooting. Probably pink heroin instead of that black tar stuff.
He was hardcore, you know. And besides, the guy, bad Carly Simon, you got to love that.
Hang on, let's give him a chance. What was it?
I said that needle's a phallic symbol.
Who?
Wow.
Ouch.
I don't think James Taylor's gay at all. It's just it's chick music, that's all.
I don't know. You know, I've gotten a lot of chicks playing that music. A
lot of guys in the audience. A lot of guys in the audience of James Taylor. Yeah. I'd say it's about 50-50.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
It shows us your sensitive side.
That's the chick part of it.
We like that.
But you're not arguing with me then?
No.
I think James is, I mean, he appeals to me, and I'm a chick, so I know.
Well, if you're comfortable enough in your masculinity, you don't need to worry about it.
Well, then what are you arguing with me for?
Huh?
What are you arguing with me for, then?
Well, cause I just think that...
You're all arguing with me, and you're all saying the same thing I'm saying.
No, it's just mellower music.
It's chick music.
I don't know about that, but...
Charlie.
I like it.
You sound to be... You're the one who's a little bit defensive about this thing.
No, I'm Charlie's gay. Jay.
Charlie's a chick.
Yeah.
Sorry. Thank you, Charlie. Here's Linda on the KGB. What's going on there, Linda?
Hey, not much, Dave. How you doing?
Good. You calling up to rat out your husband?
Totally.
Why?
Oh, my God. We've been married about 6 years. And let me tell you, 1 year, I decided to buy him a CD. It was a really cool white zombie deal. He is fully into, you know, Metallica... White Zombie, I mean, all that kind of stuff. He digs rock and roll.
Mm-hmm.
Well, he returned it for freaking Celine Dion.
Oh!
That's...
He's all, you know, I can't listen to those hard rock stations anymore.
Oh.
I've been listening to Kixie.
Oh,
it kills me.
Oh,
and it's like, wait a minute, whatever happened to Mr. Metallica, you know, party on. Oh,
right.
My God. And it's very sad.
It was compensatory back in the day, covering up with the loud music and the rock and roll music and numbing his gayness with alcohol.
Denial. Exactly. And I'm the brown gal.
Oh, damn it.
Oh, what a disappointment for you.
It's a big disappointment. Anyways.
Hang on.
My name is Eric, and...
I'm going to dial him up here.
Good.
I wish I could dial without looking at it like bank tellers and stuff can do. I've been doing this for so long, I should be able to do that, shouldn't I?
Sure.
Yes.
Like those people with Addy machines that are so quick.
Good morning, this is Eric.
Hi.
Hey, Eric, how you doing, bud?
Hey, Bert.
Eric?
Yes.
Hi, it's Dave Shelley and Chainsaw Colin. We're doing our radio show over on KGB.
Uh-huh.
How you doing, pal?
Fine.
Heard a terrible rumor about you.
What's that?
Your wife bought your pretty cool white zombie CD.
Yeah.
And you took it back to the store and you exchanged it?
Mm-hmm.
For Celine Dion.
yeah.
Oh, Eric.
How long have you been
gay?
Eric.
You got a brain tumor or something?
No.
Really?
Really.
What's the best Celine Dion song going?
Nothing anymore. I'm sick of her.
Oh.
Uh-huh.
Now, are you just putting up a cover for me here?
No, actually, I'm totally sick of her anymore.
Oh, okay, all right.
Well, what was your favorite?
Probably that thing that got played to death from...
The Titanic thing?
Yeah.
Makes me want to kill myself.
What do you think about when you're making love to your wife?
Her?
Celine Dion?
No.
Thinks about Linda.
Oh.
She's brown after all, damn it.
Yeah, she is.
Damn it.
She's brown, damn it.
So you used to be a rocker and all the hard edges are gone and you smoothed over now, huh?
Yeah, a little bit, yep.
Yeah.
In my old age.
Yeah. How old are you?
32.
Oh, man, you're not old, dude.
You should still have a mullet.
And be driving a Trans Am.
Oh, man.
You, Eric.
Yeah.
Uh-huh. Hi, baby.
Hi.
Puppy
whoppy.
You want to tell us anything ratty about Linda just to get her back right now?
No, that's okay.
Doesn't shave her leg, something like that.
No. Nope.
Wallet chain.
High
level.
Hey, that's a classy look.
He wants to live tonight.
I'm going to give Eric props for not dodging the issue. He sacked up. He admitted it. What the hell? What are you going to do?
He's a great guy.
He's a great guy who traded in his white zombie CD for Celine Dion.
Oh, my God.
You ever listen to KPRS, Eric?
No.
It's music for persons.
Stop up.
All right, thanks, bud.
Bye.
You're a good sport, Eric.
Thanks.
See you, bud. Man of few words.
Yes.
Not a lot of expression going on there. Is he pissed?
I love him.
Is he pissed?
Mildly. Maybe later.
Uh-oh.
He'll be fine. He'll be all right.
Don't do that to me again.
I do got to say he is a great guy, and I love him very much. I'm a lucky girl.
Now, has he ever traded in, like, his catcher's mitt for, like, a toaster cozy or anything like that?
No. Mm-hmm. No, it's just the...
Just the music, huh?
Just the music. That's it.
Yeah.
He's pretty macho otherwise.
Oh, that's cool.
Or he thinks he is.
What kind of work does he do for a living?
He is a junior network administrator.
Ooh, badass.
Yeah. But he does a good job.
Is that him calling you back right now?
I'm sorry?
Is that him calling you back right now?
Oh, probably.
Yeah.
Okay, guys.
Oh. All right. See you later.
I love your show.
I love yours.
Bye.
Bye.
God.
Of all the people to exchange.
That's tough. Yeah.
It's got to be the worst.
Pat Grove all night.
What was that song you played yesterday? It was the last song.
Oh, AC/DC.
You Shook Me All Night Long.
Oh, yeah, that one.
By Celine Dion.
Knocking me out that's with pretty, those American ties. That's pretty damn funny.
We kept this motor clean.
That's pretty funny.
He was the best damn woman that I ever seen.
What do you think of that little butch haircut she's wearing now?
She cut it?
Oh, yeah.
Really?
Remember, I think you even played a thing on the news about her. She didn't want to spend 3 hours doing her
damn
hair every day.
I remember that.
You know,
all short.
I don't begrudge these people their fame and their fortune. And, you know, Celine Dion, she got Caesar's Palace to build her own amphitheater. And whatever they're charging for tickets, more power to you.
Yeah.
Great success story. Mm-hmm. What I don't like, though, is when they say, you know, I just want to take time off from the concert touring so that I can make breakfast for my kids and I can take care of my husband.
What a load of crap.
Because I'm just a regular person.
No, you're not.
You know? And I'm reading this interview this week with Madonna in People magazine. And there it is, the sub-headline. I'm just leading a normal life. No, you're not. Normal people aren't on the cover of People magazine. I just wish they would stop saying that part. That's all.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
You know?
Mm-hmm.
I'm just a normal person.
Being interviewed by People magazine.
No, you're not.
First of all, there's no such thing as a normal person. But we know what she means.
But what they claim to be normal is so far away from their world.
Right.
That it's ludicrous that they would even admit it.
Yeah, it's ridiculous.
Are you going to get in your car and battle rush hour traffic, driving yourself to work and get pushed around by your boss for 8 hours?
Hell no.
That's what normal people do.
Yeah. Right.
That one interviewer is asking Michael Jackson about his kids. I mean, I think he said, your kids can never have a normal life, can they? And Michael's like, oh, no way.
Well, at least he owned up to that.
Yes, he did admit that.
But one interviewer just laugh in their faces when they say, I'm just a normal person. You are not.
Because the interviewer doesn't live a normal life either.
Yes, they do. They're too chicken to bark back and say, Obey itche on ouye. Uh-huh. Right there. Give it. Thank you.
Because their idea of a normal life is to go around interviewing more celebrities.
Kissing
like
ass.
That. Kissing ass. And they don't want to break that networking chain that they have of, kissing he's a
ass.
Good interviewer. He won't even blink when you say you live a normal life.
Yeah.
That's how it works.
Or that you're tired of being beaten down and you can't
right.
walk down the street.
And they won't actually laugh at you when you say that, J-Ho. So this is the person you want to interview you.
Normal people jingle into spots.
Pervert.
And they come back in 4 minutes with a sports update with a chainsaw.
That's right.
All while delivering the call letters of two radio stations that carry their nationally syndicated show on KGB San Diego and KGBB Temecula.
Oh.
Okay. That's what normal people do.
More San Diegans wake up with Dave, Shelley, and Chainsaw than any other radio show. KGB.
We're ready in advance.
When it comes to fuel economy, don't be fuelish. At Advance Auto Parts, we can help you save money on gas, from changing spark plugs to changing driving habits. All it takes is a little advanced planning. Stop in any Advance store today for all the facts on cutting back, because saving fuel is a gas. So bring it on. We're ready in Advance.
For the best parts, people at price, we're ready in Advance. Yeah, bring it on.
People who stop here, buy here.
It's a spring thing sales event. ready now. Kicks and fire.
No, man. Get hot dogs or serve it up meat and potatoes here at the playground tonight. The 1-1 pitch. In there, strike.
Basketball Association. Did the Lakers get cocky after everybody predicted they'd roll over Minnesota?
Yeah.
Well, actually, they rolled over themselves. The Timberwolves destroyed Los Angeles 119-91. Kevin Garnett, 35 points, 20 rebounds. And somebody named Troy Hudson scored 37 and handed out 10 assists against the Lakers. That series is tied 1-1. And the Bucks, Henry, New Jersey, that series tied 1-1. Chris Boyer, Buck Henry.
Right.
Go.
Buck Henry was the frequent guest on Saturday Night Live. He was the creative consultant on Get Smart.
He was the co-creator along with Mel Brooks. Go ahead.
Heaven Can Wait, the screenplay.
The Graduate.
The Graduate, the screenplay.
And he was Uncle Roy on Saturday Night Live, the crazy, creepy uncle who always wanted to take pictures of Lorraine Newman and
Gilda
Radner in their underwear.
Who gives a rat's ass?
Well, apparently, Buck Henry. Thank you, Chris. Huh. In other sports, Dave.
So, Darling's dickie goes all the way up to his mouth.
Yeah.
Your dickie falls short of that, landing somewhere around your neck.
Right, Adam's apple.
Has that dickie ever bulged before?
Mm. Only on the Adam's apple.
Seems to me I've heard news reports about that.
Really?
But other NFL news, Patriots cornerback Maurice Hurst today cleared out his locker and then cleared out of the New England facility without comment. The 7-year veteran cut by head coach Bill Parcells. Hurst was burned on 240-yard pass plays in the Pats' 24-10 home loss to Indy yesterday. And now the agent for Hurst has come out and said he will file a grievance against the Patriots that, according to NFL rules, the club should not have been able to release his client because he was injured. The agent claims that at the request of the team, Hurst has been playing with a bulging disc in his neck.
Oh. More dickies in sports than you really think about it.
It really is.
No.
It's 8:44 and 9 seconds.
The first base umpire, Gary Darling, has a dickie that goes up around his mouth.
This is your 101.5 KGB Sports Network.
Oh, my. The Chainsaw brought to you by Olhausen Billiards Game Room Superstore. You're going to find everything you need for your game room there. Family fun starts at 5620 Kearney Mesa Road. Half-baked crackpot news is dangerously close, ladies and gentlemen. Here's Tom on the KGB. What's going on there, Tom?
Hey, Dave, how you doing?
Tip-top, talk to me, Cooker.
I'm playing golf with you this afternoon.
Beautiful.
Can you tell me the difference? You said it was best ball.
Right.
And I thought it was a scramble. But it's best ball where everybody plays and the best score on the hole is the team score?
I screwed up. It is not that. It's everyone tees off, and you take whoever the group thinks is the best tee shot, and then everyone goes to there.
All right, cool. That's what I thought it was.
My bad.
To make sure.
My bad. I've confused that. I've confused that more than once.
Ain't nothing bad when you got the Hamul Open going.
The Hamul Open today, buddy.
You betcha.
So what is that called? Is that called best ball or scramble?
Scramble.
Okay, good.
So when you shoot the scramble second.
And Dave, is it a shotgun start?
Yes.
Okay, cool. Perfect. 1 o'clock, right?
I think that's the time. Is that the time? I still haven't gotten clarification on it.
Break.
Yeah, go ahead, Chris. I got my ears on.
I was told to be there at 12:30. 1 o'clock start.
Okay, all right. Any Smokies out there I want to watch out for? Okay.
Dave, I do have one more question. Now, how's Boyer going to golf with his CB radio?
Well, that's only during the confines of the radio program, but I would like to point out that I believe Chris Boyer has set a world endurance record for time on the CB microphone. All he's got to do is say something clever or amusing that makes us laugh, and
so far nothing.
But he's waiting for that.
But he's in deficit because he's had a couple of clinkers while on the CB microphone, meaning he has three or four good ones to go. I mean, you're the final judge, but if you're keeping track at home, three or four baddies requires three or four goodies before he's off.
For my money, the poor boy's hit rock bottom.
Yeah,
you know, at that point, you just, of course, he's starting to dig now that he's hit rock bottom.
See, that's what happens.
He's scraping at hard pan right now.
Yeah.
Dave, let's go hit him straight.
Oh.
I'm sorry, what was that, Chris Boyer?
Knowing me, I'll blast and dig deeper. I'm very confident of that.
All right, Tom.
Let's go hit them straight.
All right, bud.
Later.
Looking forward to seeing you, Steel Canyon. Let's get a traffic update here on the KGB, and then it's Crackpot News here. Here's Route 66.
Thank you, Dave. Slow traffic continuing north 805 up over the 52 into the Golden Triangle. South 5 heavy on the coast, Leucadia Boulevard down to Manchester. South 15 still bunched up in Escondido with more brake lights, Mercy to Mira Mesa. It's working a wreck northbound 5 approaching Sereno Valley and another one northbound 5 past La Jolla Village. I'm Ruth 66 with Dave, Shelley, and Chainsaw on the 101.5 KGB.
Starfleet is looking for a few good officers.
Set a new course.
Do something!
Fire! Join Starfleet 5 flights a week with Star Trek Voyager tonight at 7 and Deep Space 9 tonight at 10 on UPN 13 San Diego, your Star Trek station.
Engage.
Where should you go? A local family-owned dealer or the one owned by a big corporation?
Go for the excellence. Cunningham.
I'm Gina Cunningham from Cunningham BMW. At Cunningham, our family has given excellent customer service for over 40 years. We've developed thousands of long-lasting relationships. Since 1990, BMW measures customer satisfaction and gives its Center of Excellence Award to just 15 out of 350 dealers. Cunningham is the only San Diego dealership to win this award 9 times. You won't find us on the stock exchange. You will find us just off Interstate 8 at the El Cajon Boulevard exit.
Go for the excellence, Cunningham.
Get financing as low as 2.9% APR on new 325 coupes and 4 doors on approved credit through BMW Financial Services.
Go for the excellence, Cunningham.
Cunningham BMW.
Angela, a 25-year-old travel agent, checked with Freeway Insurance and saved $293 on her auto insurance.
That's the ticket.
Jose, a 38-year-old gardener, checked with Freeway and saved $521 for his family.
That's a lot of green.
Mark, age and occupation anonymous, did not check with Freeway.
Oh, nuts!
He paid $726 too much. Next time, you better check with Freeway, where you get the lowest total price, the lowest down payment, and the lowest monthly payment on auto insurance. Listen, call other companies if you want, but if you forget to check with Freeway, you could be missing hundreds of dollars in savings. So be like Barbara, the receptionist who checked and saved $982.
Hello, and thanks, Freeway.
Call Freeway at 1-800-464-SAVE. That's 1-800-464-SAVE. Or log on to freewayinsurance.com. Remember the name, Freeway. It's that thing you're speeding on.
Denny's wisdom number 31. It's not really breakfast if you have to pour it from a blender. At Denny's, we serve breakfast that you have to eat with a fork. A real breakfast that's real good. Like the hearty new Denny's Meat Lover's Breakfast, served with savory, mouth-watering grilled honey ham, 2 strips of crispy bacon, and 2 pieces of tasty sausage. Plus, you get 3 fluffy pancakes, 2 eggs cooked to order just the way you like them, and golden hash browns, all for just $4.99 and all complete with eggs, pancakes, and more. Grab a big fork and try a real breakfast you can sink your teeth into. Denny's new hearty Meat Lover's Breakfast, just $4.99. Real breakfast that's real good. Available only at where else? Denny's. Start every day sunny side up. Denny's, a good place to sit and eat.
Price and participation may vary for a limited time only.
Question. Can anyone get your Ford car or truck ready for spring better than your participating dealership?
For our maintenance value package. For just $34.95 or less, you'll get a Motorcraft oil and filter change, tire rotation, fluid top off, belts and hoses check, battery test, brake inspection, and more. For a limited time, just $34.95. Stop by and enter to win a trip to the Caribbean or to the world premiere of this summer's hot new movie, Pirates of the Caribbean, The Curse of the Black Pearl, in theaters July 9th. Quality Care Auto Service. Who knows your vehicle better? See your participating Southern California Ford dealer today.
Up to 5 quarts of Motorcraft oil, taxes and disposal fees extra. No purchase required for sweepstakes. See participating dealership for price, service hours, and sweepstakes rules through 52503.
I hope you get an ear out for that KGB cash clock. It winds down, we pay up. And this is the the granddaddy of them all this week. You know how this works. The clock is ticking. It slows down. It slows down. It slows down. When it finally conks out, you have to be the correct caller. 866-525-WINS. And it's $100,000. $100,000. Coming up in just a few minutes here on the KGB. On the news today, we're going to hear from, I believe, Kiss is going to talk to us today? The same?
No.
No? No?
No.
What is Kiss?
I don't know.
Oh, the first lesbian Kiss is what we're talking about.
Oh, yeah. That's on All My Children. And we've got Bianca and Lena talking about how they made out.
Matt Dillon's going to talk to us. Who's Frederique?
She is a model.
That goofy model?
Oofy. She was on Celebrity Mole.
Yeah.
That beautiful blonde. Wasn't she Victoria's Secret for years?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, she's talking about this new endeavor.
Now she's Sears.
No, she's in a play.
She created her own line of lingerie.
She's in one of your favorite plays, the monologues.
Oh, great.
She's an actress?
Well,
I don't think you have to act all that much for what she's in.
But with our top story for today on the Half-Baked Crackpot News, here is Shelley Dunn.
Thank you. Hey, they've got electricity in some parts of Baghdad now, and that's been cause for celebration. You can imagine being without power all this time. The mood was somber, though, as others dug through graves discovered at a notorious prison. They're trying to find traces of their missing relatives. People say that countless men were executed there in the final days of the Saddam Hussein regime. The U.S. is bringing more of its military hardware home. About 10 attack jets are returning today and more are due tomorrow as the focus shifts to post-war tasks. The Pentagon's budget chief says there's no current estimate of how much reconstruction of the country will cost.
Now that they've got electricity, they can recharge their bullhorns to further yell out the message, Americans, go home.
Yeah, we're going to talk a little bit about that.
You're welcome.
There are six Iraqi scientists. They say that under Saddam Hussein, they were ordered to destroy or hide substances that appeared suspicious. The orders reportedly sometimes came hours before the UN weapons inspectors arrived. The scientists say the substances were not weapons, but they just seemed suspicious. Meanwhile, investigators are trying to figure out how hundreds of millions of U.S. dollars ended up in Iraq despite U.N. sanctions. The Secret Service checking to see if these piles of $100 bills are actually genuine. The $100 bill is the most counterfeited U.S. note outside the U.S. If they are legitimate bills, though, they could have come into Iraq through oil or cash smuggling schemes, illegal trade deals, maybe a sham business. U.S. soldiers discovered more than $600 million. They were in packets of new $100 bills hidden behind a false wall in Baghdad.
Sweet.
$656 million was found last week in a neighborhood along the Tigris River. An additional $112 million found sealed inside seven animal kennels in that same neighborhood. Sadly, though, there are four American soldiers who've been arrested for trying to steal nearly $1 million of Saddam's cash. Three of the GIs accused of taking $600,000, hiding it in a tree near a cottage. The fourth soldier wanted $300,000 of his own, hid it in a bag.
This is like that movie. That World War II movie, when they were trying to steal all the Nazi gold. Donald Sutherland was in it. He was a tank driver. Yeah.
Evidently, it's a little bit like Three Kings as well. The George Clooney and doing the same thing. Well, anyway, the MPs found it. One guy was trying to hide $300,000 in the cargo truck glove compartment. Sadly, they now face a court martial.
Wads of dough sticking out of the glove box.
You're there to liberate, not liberate the money.
Yep.
Thousands of Muslims in Iraq and a religious held a
So the 100 is the most counterfeited bill.
Yes.
You ever lay down a one of the new 100s or one of the new 20s, and the clerk gets out the secret pen and draws on it?
I know.
And you know why they're doing it, but isn't there just a tiniest flash of what do I look like, a counterfeiter to you?
Well, what goes through my mind is, oh, no, what if it's counterfeit? I'll never remember
screwed.
I got it. Yeah. I'm screwed.
And now that they've got all these new bills, the whole point of making these new dollars, these new hundreds and everything, mm-hmm. was because they're virtually impossible to counterfeit.
Right.
Now you're checking them? Shouldn't have been before?
I know.
Shouldn't you be checking the old ones?
No kidding.
Kind of backwards, isn't it?
Yeah, and I wonder if this big stockpile they found are the new hundreds or the old hundreds. Because the new hundreds, too, have that strip in them, that magnetic strip.
Yep.
That you're supposed to be able to, radar can pick it up, I guess.
Dan, you're on a KGB. What's going on?
Hey, the movie you're talking about, classic Clint Eastwood, Donald Sutherland. It's Kelly's Heroes.
Yeah, I remember that. They bust into the building and they steal all that Nazi gold.
Yeah, they actually have a German help them at the end. Or actually, it's the guy who was there guarding the all the gold at the end.
Yeah, that's a great movie.
Excellent movie. It's classic.
Kelly's Heroes. Thanks, Dan.
Yep, bye. Okay.
Well, let's move on to the anti-American protests.
This was good.
Thousands of Muslims in Iraq on a religious pilgrimage have staged this anti-American protest. A large crowd held a demonstration today. They had signs that said, no to America, no to Israel, yes to Islam. Hundreds of thousands of these Shiite Muslims have marched to their shrine in Karbala, chanting, swaying, even cutting their own bodies in an emotional ritual that had been banned for decades under Saddam Hussein. You wouldn't think you'd have to ban something like that. Anyway, the annual pilgrimage marks the end of a 40-day mourning period, culminates this Thursday. The White House says they welcome the huge Shiite pilgrimage in Iraq. They warn, though, that Iraq mustn't become an Iranian-style Islamic state. President Bush, though, welcomes the march as a demonstration of Iraq's new religious freedom, even though some marchers held those anti-U.S. signs. Now, there's a guy named Craig Wynn. He is a terrorism expert, and he says, uh-oh, we invaded the wrong country in our worldwide war on terror. He says that Syria is a much greater terrorist threat.
And Syria is a very serious foe to the United States in terms of its willingness to perpetrate terror around the world.
He says that Iran also has its fingerprints all over worldwide terror and that the country must maybe just months away from developing a nuclear bomb. He says Syria and Iran are both major supporters of terrorist groups.
Iran is a far more serious threat, and they are equally as bloody as it relates to the invasion of Lebanon, as they created Hezbollah. And the reason they're so frightening to us is they're within 6 months of having a thermonuclear device.
And so he reiterates we should have targeted Syria and Iran in our war.
He said nuclear, didn't he?
I think he did.
Thermonuclear.
Yeah.
Syria is far more of a hotbed for terrorism than Iraq ever was. The fact of the matter is that Iran, which partners with Syria in all aspects of terror, founded Hezbollah.
Now, last night...
I have no idea what you just said there, buddy, but there was a lot of blah, blah, blah in there.
Well, Hezbollah is usually the ones that take responsibility for anything that happens in Israel, and I guess he's saying that they're either holed up in Syria or Iran.
Blah, blah, blah.
And last night, on PBS's Charlie Rose show, Colin Powell talked about the U.S. relationship with France, North Korea, terrorism, and Syria, which the U.S. has said is on the list of countries that support terrorism. So Secretary of State Powell talked about recent concerns that we have with Syria.
We have been particularly concerned in recent weeks, for obvious reasons, over any transit of Iraqi leaders into Syria or fedayeen from Syria into Iraq, or any movement across the border during the period of Operation Iraqi Freedom.
Can't we get to like celebrity news? I have no idea what these guys are saying. Do you understand that?
Yeah, I do. I understand what they're saying.
Boring.
Feel safer today, though, because our Homeland Security Chief Tom Ridge is going to be in San Diego and TJ today, meeting with our own Dick Murphy and a group of Homeland Security Department employees, Dick, as well as his Mexican counterpart. Dick, who I hear is back in the race for our mayor. Did you hear what the Republican Pennsylvania senator has said about homosexual behavior?
No.
He's compared it. His name is Rick Santorum. He compares homosexuality to polygamy, incest, and adultery.
Good grief.
He was talking about the Supreme Court case challenging Texas sodomy law. We talked about that, I think, on the news earlier. The Republican senator noted that if the Supreme Court rules there's a privacy right to sodomy, then laws against polygamy and incest could also be found unconstitutional. Well, the Catholic League for Religious and Civil Rights also defends him for expressing the, quote, Christian understanding of marriage. In other news, U.S. Officials and China and North Korean officials sat down at the negotiating table for the first time in 50 years today. What we're trying to do with China, the U.S. is trying to ensure that North Korea does not build nuclear weapons. The North Korean government has maintained its nuclear program is only for electricity. We're suspicious, saying that it's designed to build a nuclear arsenal. Thousands of people in China are trying to get out of Beijing as the SARS epidemic continues. The World Health Organization says it wants to double-check a report. This report says that this disease was spread by sewage leaks and other environmental factors in a Hong Kong apartment complex.
Well, you know, little Wai Mei's had her return to China postponed.
That's what I was just going to tell you about. They don't say when they're going to send her back, but they don't think the panda could actually get it, but they're afraid that the people who would have to go with her or the people they would contact once they get her back to China would, you know, give them some of that bad stuff.
Right, her peeps.
That's right. Well, let's move on to the Peterson case. Now, remember the woman, Amber Fry, who came forward and said, I had an affair with Scott Peterson?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
This poor thing, she's now keeping a low profile as the prosecutors prepare their case. Here's Clear Channel's own Rob Johnson in Modesto, where Amber Fry is keeping it on the down low.
Being out on the sky is not particularly a good thing at all.
Hey, where's Rob? What'd you do with
they
Rob?
I don't want her to talk publicly anymore about any of her involvement with Scott, because in my... it's my opinion she's going to be a chief witness in the trial.
So this reporter, our guy Rob Johnson, has been in touch with Fry's family and says shortly before being arrested, Scott Peterson, down here in San Diego, kept calling Amber on the phone. Now, they had this affair around the time that Lacey disappeared. The New York Post says Scott Peterson tearfully told Fry he was single and had lost his wife a year before.
Good grief.
So was Scott trying to rekindle a romance with Amber?
I have talked to her family and her sister in particular. I have learned that Scott Peterson has spent a lot of time in Fresno in the last few weeks, and he's tried to contact Amber. He's left repeated phone messages, dozens of phone messages for her at her home.
Fry's father says he was suspicious of Scott Peterson from the start. Meanwhile, close friends of Scott and Lacey gave their views of the marriage and talked about a phone conversation they had with Scott Peterson on the day that Lacey was said to have disappeared. That would be Christmas Eve. These are their friends Gregory and Kristen Reed. They took Lamaze classes with the Petersons. Mm-hmm. Gregory Reed says Scott Peterson called him that day by cell phone, and which to him didn't seem unusual because they were trying to formalize plans for spending New Year's Eve together.
He sounded... chipper and looking forward to getting together.
So Kristen, the wife, says a happy holiday changed with a frantic voicemail message from Scott Peterson.
It went from, you know, a wonderful celebration of Christmas to a frantic, you know, voicemail message from Scott that evening, looking for Lacey, wondering if I had talked to her that morning. And it was just, it's hard to bring up.
Peterson, meanwhile, has not actually received direct death threats from other maximum security inmates. Even so, Stanislaus County Sheriff's Office spokesman Kelly Houston says precautions are being taken.
Certainly some folks in here in our maximum security tier who are three strikers would love to get an opportunity to become notorious themselves by accessing him. So that poses some security concerns, especially since he's such a noteworthy inmate within the maximum security tier.
Well, let's move on. I know. Let's move on to that kiss. It happens today, a soap opera first, the first lesbian kiss on daytime TV on All My Children on ABC today. Now, this is the scene between Bianca and Lena. Eden Reigel, who plays Bianca, and Olga, who plays Lena, both asked how it felt to do a scene like this. Eden will speak first.
I was nervous, I have to say, only because...
I guess because...
I wanted it to be a payoff for the fans, and I didn't want it to look tentative, even though, you know, I kind of felt that way. I wanted it to seem really and very comfortable, and, I mean, Olga is so great. She put me completely at ease.
It's always bizarre to do any kind of love scene.
Nice fake accent.
Speaking as a married woman, you know, it's always going to feel strange for me to be kissing anybody, male or female. So just the fact that it was physically slightly different just made it a little bit more bizarre. But, you know, that's the only difference.
What'd she say?
I don't know.
She said it was weird kissing a chick. She's not used to it.
Exactly.
I was nervous, I have to say.
Yes.
I guess because
yes.
It hasn't been such a showcase. You know what I mean? It's been more about doing records that are good records. You know what I mean? And I think on this album, too, it was more of a thing where I was like, you know what? Let me really sing in my sweet spot instead of like reaching up and going down.
So it turns out it's Bianca on the receiving end of the kiss from Lena. Does she think this is controversial?
I'm not sure why this subject is as controversial.
Oh, shut up! Shut up!
In an enlightened world, right?
God. Oh.
All My Children had the first lesbo character like 25 some years ago.
Sure why this subject is as controversial as it is, but it's about time we did it.
What
and I'm glad to see that the response has been so positive. To just the idea of seeing two women intimate on screen.
Hell yeah. Who doesn't want to see that?
Six guys with a sock.
Cuties like them.
Well, you are going to be sliding off your chair today, Ruthie.
No.
Olga slash Lena says she thinks the scene was handled beautifully.
It's not just a story about two lesbians. It's not gratuitous.
And yeah, right.
Ratings, actually.
The audience knows and loves and wants to be happy, and why would they possibly begrudge her this happiness?
I tell you what, there was a lesbian kiss on TV last night. I'm flipping through, and I see Not Another Teen Movie. Have you seen this?
Uh-uh.
No.
Was it the one where the staircase collapses?
Yeah, that's the one. Yeah. And there's this chick in the movie who is just, she'll do anybody, anything, anywhere, anytime.
Yeah.
Wow. I've known her.
And she's at this party, and there's this old lady there.
Uh-oh.
And they make out.
Ah!
And the makeup guys, they make out.
Wow.
You see tonsils, you see uvulas, tongues, everything.
Ooh.
And the makeup guys, before the scene, they smeared the old woman's mouth with, like, this sticky syrup. So when they pull away...
Nice.
You're killing me. Stop it.
It's over the top. Over the top.
Did they do the inside the mouth camera and everything with the uvulas and all that?
Pretty bad.
Have you seen the Discovery Channel, What a Kiss Really Looks Like, with the camera inside the mouth?
Really?
Oh, yeah.
To see that.
Don't need to.
Yeah. That'd be funny, though, in a movie like that.
So, back to the lesbian kiss on All My Children. Say, girls, was that scene improvised at all?
It's not just a story about two lesbians. It's not.
Is that the right one?
Next one.
We more or less followed the stage directions, and the decision was initiated by Lena, but obviously, you know, there was no resistance on
the part. That's right. She was breaking up with her.
Well, I know, but I think she's doing it because she doesn't want to break her heart, because she knows that Michael's going to make her do it, you know, deviously.
Mm-hmm. Is there any more on the kiss?
One more. Let's see. Will there be a homosexual kiss next?
Oh, jeez.
That seems like a logical next step.
Oh, no, it doesn't. Shut up. There
are no male gay characters on many other soaps right now, so I do hope that the other soaps sort of follow our lead. And
why? Don't listen to her. She has nothing to say.
It's coming.
We will continue the half-day crackpot news here on KGB. Let's get a traffic update. Here's Ruthie.
Still working a wreck northbound 5 just past La Jolla Village Drive. It's in the fast lane. Another one clearing northbound 5 approaching Sereno Valley. Southbound 5 still bunched up Acadia Boulevard down to Encinitas now down to Loma Santa Fe. And some leftover slowing north 805 over the 52. Earn a great rate on overnight funds with high-yield checking from Pacific Trust Bank and get free online checking and bill payment service, too. For details, call 1-877-441-BANK or on the web, pacifictrustbank.com. I'm Ruth 66 with Dave Shelley and Tane Song, 101.5 KGB.
For the Harley-Davidson motorcycle you've always wanted, see San Diego Harley-Davidson, 5600 Kearny Mesa Road. It's the journey, San Diego Harley-Davidson.
CNM's leasing Tahoe LSs for $359 a month. Drive a Tahoe for only $359 a month, plus tax for 60 months on approved credit. Get the most dependable, best-built, longest-lasting trucks on the road with air, CD, third-row seat, 12,000 miles per year, and 20 cents per mile over. There's zero security deposit, $1,000 cash or trade equity, plus the $3,000 factory rebate, totals the $4,000 due at lease signing. Through April 30th, get the Tahoe you've always dreamed of and a payment that's like a dream come true. $359 a month. In between the 163 and the 805 on Balboa in Kearny Mesa.
We're going to satisfy you, baby.
Hi.
Come on in.
Here, a little housewarming gift.
Thanks. Well, this is the place.
It's beautiful. Oh, my gosh.
We love it.
I love the location. How on earth did they find this place?
When we saw it, we knew this was the one.
Well, it's just one in a million. More like a zillion. I never saw this listing.
Come on back. It's even got a pool.
A pool? Okay, I will not push her into the pool.
Don't miss out on your dream home. Find it first at signonsandiego.com by the Union Tribune, the source for San Diego's most comprehensive, up-to-date listing of local homes anywhere online. You can customize your search to find homes that fit your style, location, and budget even faster. Signonsandiego.com. If you're looking for a home, get on it.
They had backups, but we were first.
Well, what can I say? It was meant to be.
Meant to be for me.
Have a good night's sleep on us. Mattress Discounters. Lay on it. Play on it. Save on it. Pray on it. Think on it. Drink on it.
Save big during Mattress Discounters special purchase sale. Save between 10% and 30% off selected top name brand mattresses, including Sealy Posturepedics and Simmons Beauty Rests. Thanks to Mattress Discounter's huge buying power, we've made a special purchase of some of our best-selling Simmons Beauty Rest and Sealy Posturepedic sets. For example, queen sets normally priced at $999 are now only $699. That's a $300 savings. You'll find similar savings on king sets as well. Don't miss Mattress Discounter's special purchase sale going on now.
Have a good night's sleep on us. Have a good night's sleep on us. Mattress Discounters.
Kearny Mesa Ford's doing it again with your choice of towering savings. That's right, your choice. Every Explorer four-door in stock, 4x2 or 4x4, doesn't matter. Get 7,000 net savings, every one. 7,000 net savings. Or how about F-150 Supercabs? 7,000 net savings. And not just on one or two, my friend. We're talking every one, 7,000 net savings. With Kearny Mesa Ford's huge inventory, you're choosing from over 800 available new and Ford-certified pre-owned trucks, SUVs, cars, and vans. Take advantage of 0% APR financing on approved credit on just about every new Ford available. Not low rates. We're talking no rates at 0%. And if we make a deal, we'll pay off your trade no matter what you owe. Just look for the tower between the 805 and 163 freeways at 7303 Claremont Mesa Boulevard. Just minutes from anywhere, it's Kearny Mesa Ford.
Kearny Mesa Ford, your tower of savings.
Savings include 4,000 KMF discount from MSRP and factory rebates of 3,000 in Louisville OAPR option. Sale ends Sunday.
Hello, this is Amy.
Did you get my email?
What?
I sent you an email. Did you get it?
No, I'm away from my office right now.
How about the page? Did you get the page?
I forgot my pager at home this morning. Listen, who is this?
Oh, I'm sorry. Where are my manners? I'm the thief.
The who?
The thief. I've been trying to reach you because I broke into your car, and I'm driving it toward the reservoir right now.
Uh-huh.
And I just wanted you to know what was happening so you can, you know, call the police, recover your car, get me busted, that kind of stuff.
When your car has the new LoJack Early Warning Recovery System, whoever steals it may as well let you know what they're doing. Because with this new concept in vehicle security, you'll be alerted via phone, pager, and email if your car's being stolen. So you can notify the police, have LoJack activated, and get your car back quickly.
Okay, well, thanks for letting me know.
No problem. Listen to me just blabbing away. I should get off the phone so you can call the police and get them on the case.
You'll find LoJack Early Warning at automobile dealers. For a dealer near you, visit LoJack.com. LoJack. Keep it close.
Quarter after nine on the KGB, it's Dave, Shelley, and Chainsaw with you. And we're in the middle of the half-big crackpot news right now. What else is going on, Shell?
Well, I have some news about some old-time Hollywood celebrities that we all know about before they were really, really big. Before he was a superstar, a 30-year-old Humphrey Bogart used to have to find and deliver male escorts to Howard Hughes. That is the truth, according to a book coming out this June called The Secret Life of Humphrey Bogart. It claims that Hughes made Bogey do all sorts of dirty jobs for him because Bogey was afraid that Hughes would tell his then-wife, Mary Phillips, that Humphrey was humping around on her.
Humping around?
Humping around. Humphrey humping. The book also claims that Bogey took 1930s sex symbol Jean Harlow, who never wore underwear and always slept in the nude, to TJ for a secret abortion because Hughes had knocked her up. It even claims that Bogart and his first wife, Helen Menken, once had a three-way with actress Tallulah Bankhead.
Tallulah Bankhead?
Yes. never thought she was.
I'm just adding outrageous ancillary comments.
I really appreciate
Nicely
that.
Nicely done.
Thank you.
Ancillary that comments, that's a good thing to put on if you have a... Never mind, I almost boyered. Good one, Chris. You're almost out.
Are you going to do anything to get off the CB mic today?
I'm so out of my wheelhouse, I feel lost.
I am apologetic as to the lack of inspiration.
It's been the whole show.
Abortions aren't really funny, David.
What?
Oh.
What do you
think? The story about the woman who was shuttled to Tijuana for an abortion, it doesn't really...
Why are you talking like an idiot?
How can you tell the difference?
What can we do lower than a CB microphone?
McDonald's microphone. Hello, can I check your order?
Duct tape.
A drive-up window?
Yes! A clown speaker! Like in the clown face.
A big clown hat?
Yes!
All right.
I think it would be great.
Better get on your game, buddy.
I'll try, David.
Thank you. Any Smokies?
Suburban Mexican food drive-up window.
Oh, good God.
I'll just turn him off for a while.
He's never lasted the whole show before, has he?
No. Just not his personal best.
And all at least an hour of yesterday's show, right?
Yep.
Yeah. Wow. Well, let's move on. If there's anyone out there besides Ben Affleck who still doesn't fully understand the personal hell he will be entering into if he doesn't marry J-Ho, consider this. Whenever Ben wants to call J-Ho, he's got to go through her personal assistant just like everybody else.
Really?
Run, Ben, run. You're running out of chances.
Oh, my God.
By the way, in case you're wondering, Kate Hudson now makes $7 million per movie because she's better and prettier than we are.
Well, did you see though, J-Lo and Ben just bought a friggin' island?
No!
An island.
For her ass?
This just in. Ben and J-Lo have just bought Earth.
They own it. We all pay rent now.
That's right. You all have to pay.
They bought this little island perfect for having a little private wedding ceremony.
Oh,
and wink, wink.
Oh,
and Entertainment Tonight. Big story.
Oh, good Lord.
I watch television.
Remember the Go-Go's guitarist, Charlotte?
Well,
she
was the blonde, the drummer, I think.
I think you're right. And
yeah, you mean the guitarist was the drummer, you think?
What just happened?
Charlotte, isn't she the drummer?
I have guitarist, Ruthie. That's what I have.
Okay.
Remember the guitarist for the Go-Go's? She was the drummer, wasn't she?
She played the drums with the guitars. It was really awesome.
I missed that part.
She's beautiful.
No, she's not.
I'd like to do her.
Get out!
She's not that cute.
Hey!
Far from beautiful.
Well, maybe
Charlotte Caffey, right?
Right, exactly. And remember Tina Yothers, who used to be in Family Ties, the blonde that we had on our show?
Yeah, she sang
she
on our show.
She's a singer now, exactly. So the two of them are together, Tina and Charlotte, hard at work on a new project, a musical about Deep Throat star Linda Lovelace. Tina playing Linda.
A musical about Deep Throat?
You wouldn't think she could sing that well. Anyway, Charlotte writing the music. This has got hits stamped all over it, and it will make its debut June 20th in a little playhouse in Hollywood called Theater of Notes. I was hoping that one day we'd get to a point where there would be nothing left to say about the Dixie Chicks and their PR disaster, but unfortunately...
We're going to be on TV tomorrow night.
Oh, yeah, on Diane Sawyer's Primetime Live.
Yeah.
And the boss, Bruce, has chosen to chime in with his unasked-for opinion on the matter. He says, quote, "To me, Dixie Chicks are terrific American artists, expressing American values by using their American right to free speech. For them to be banished wholesale from radio stations and even entire radio networks for speaking out is un-American."
No, Bruce, it's actually totally American, but thanks for trying. Would you like to move to some easier questions? You won't look like quite such a dope. I mean, we know you're a constitutional scholar, just like Tim and Susan and Madonna, but you got that one exactly wrong.
Well, I told you yesterday about the first federal lawsuit filed in connection with the Great White Concert Fire, and they're going after everyone, even the beer company. The suit names Great White, the owners of that club, the fire marshals, the state of Rhode Island, and Anheuser-Busch. They claim that the beer company was sponsor of the show, and that contributed to the concert's capacity, and they claim, the suit does, that the beer maker arranged for a batch of Bud to be delivered to the club so fans could have the freshest beer, and then the suit alleges alcohol interfered with the ability of the patrons to find the exits. So wouldn't the patrons be in trouble for being drunk? Anyway, survivors of the Great White Concert Fire were treated to a benefit concert last night to remember and to raise money for the victims. They got to see BOC, Blue Oyster Cult, Rick Derringer, members of Molly Hatchet, Blackfoot, and the Rossington Band. They sold 3,000 tickets.
Wow.
500 given to families and victims of survivors.
The Rossington Band?
Yeah, berber.
That's a coup.
Yeah.
And goody, Matt Dillon has a new movie out, and it's his debut as a director. He also co-wrote the script and stars in the film as well. It's called City of Ghosts. Dillon plays a con man who leaves the U.S. to find, or in order to avoid an insurance scam. He, of course, goes to Cambodia, where we all go when you want to flee the country, to find Marvin, a guy played by James Caan. Matt Dillon talks about some of the problems they faced while shooting in the actual country of Cambodia.
What am I doing?
Yeah, they hit the button.
Which one?
Matt Dillon.
Oh, it's way out of line.
Aww.
We did have to clear some areas for landmines that we were shooting in. Jeez. We had to rebuild roads. We didn't want to lose anybody driving up the mountain. My first AD reminds me of some of the insanity that was going on while we were making the film. I mean, there was one day he pointed out, he said, okay. I said, well, it wasn't that bad. We didn't have many problems. He said, what about the time the electric department was held hostage?
Oh, I remember that.
Oh, yeah, I forgot about that one. There were things like that. But overall, that stuff was kind of fun. Yeah. You know, I enjoyed
the
obstacle.
Take a breath.
He's afraid we'll cut him off.
Hang on, here's listener Bobby.
Bobby.
Hey, Bobby.
Oh, fun. I thought I was calling DSC. Are you the Lollipop Kids now?
What's up, Bobby?
Well, I have to touch on something that you said.
Touch it.
Well, I don't really want to touch it. I'm not that tight, but why are you making fun of J-Lo?
There's so much reason to make fun of Jennifer Lopez.
Yeah, somewhat. But so if she has enough money to buy an island, more power to her. Give the rest of us
inspiration. Well, we more make fun of her because she has an assistant to tweak her nipples. She has two eyebrow assistants. She has an assistant to hold her jacket.
It's just media stuff.
Yeah, but then she comes out and talks about how difficult her life is.
It's one of the prices you pay for doing this. And
I'm tearing
it
up.
It does beat you down.
Yeah,
if you're
going
to make fun of her, go on Julia Roberts instead.
Oh, we do her, too.
We love making fun
Julia
of her.
Roberts is one of the top three. J-Lo just keeps coming up with such good stuff.
I know.
She's unbeatable.
Yeah. Did you see that? So pretty.
So pretty.
How about when she said Republican is in the dictionary between Republic and Reptile?
Who said that?
Julia Roberts, quote in the Limbaugh letter once.
Yeah,
she said that.
So
I don't have any problem with anybody buying an island. More power to her. Gives me inspiration because I want to buy an island.
All right, Bobby.
Too bad. Yeah.
Okay.
Later,
Bobby.
Aw. She's a little pissed off.
She had some tood, Charles. How
a little
we
tood.
We
right.
Street peeps
oh,
talk because we got
street.
The crud money dog word peeps.
What?
Huh?
What do you say when you say that?
Crud money word dog peeps.
I'm white.
What?
Yeah.
I don't understand that because I'm white.
Fat.
Wow. Fat.
Fat. Fat.
What are you saying?
It's sick. PH fat.
Oh.
Fat.
That is so sick.
Ooh.
Serious.
Sick.
Word.
You feeling
Cavassier, dog.
Yeah.
What's that mean?
Don't you know anything?
No.
Apparently not.
Watch a little BET.
Cavassier, dog.
What does that mean?
Do I need to play P. Diddy's song called Cavassier, Pass the Cavassier?
I've never heard of it.
Oh, cool you're song. So Caucasian.
You noticed.
You know, why don't you just get your Bible and go to church? What else do we have, Shel? We're going to talk to Frederique?
Yeah, we're going to talk to Frederique. She's the supermodel who's she was the mole on Celebrity Mole, and now she's getting her own syndicated show. She's in final talks to host a lifestyle show that she hopes will start with a special next November and then go into a weekly series. So Frederique, who's appearing in a production of The Vagina Monologues,
good,
says
good.
Women in her country are not embarrassed by talking about their vaginas like American
What's her
women
country?
Are. I don't know. I think German.
When I get asked, like, oh, did you get embarrassed with the idea that you have to talk about vaginas? And being from Holland, I think, is a huge difference because there's nothing embarrassing about it except that why did they name it a name which sounds like vagina?
Well, if there's nothing embarrassing about it, let's see it. How about that?
Yeah.
I don't think she does that in the Vagina Monologues.
Why? Was she embarrassed of?
I don't know. Maybe in Holland she would show you, but not here.
Right.
Well, so is she going to get into acting full-time? No, she doesn't want to give up the varied life she lives now.
Acting is something you have to say 100%, okay, this...
Have you ever acted in your life and now all of a sudden you're Laurence Olivier?
Go stick a finger in another dyke.
Acting!
Acting is something I have to say 100%. Okay, this is what I'm doing. It takes an enormous amount of work.
Is this the bass singer for the Oak Ridge Boys?
An enormous dedication to a lifestyle of being away on the road. At this point, I have a 3-year-old, so I actually
shut up! Jeez, God, none of these people are interesting today.
Well, here's one that's going to make you hate Frederique.
Oh.
She was born with these damn jeans that let her eat all she wants, and she never gets fat.
So pretty.
Bitch. Oh, sorry.
I have a certain gene set up. There's a certain...
Yeah, it's the finger gene.
Yeah. You have a certain gene set up.
That's what makes her voice so deep. It's all that stomach acid scraping across her vocal cords.
If you want to pick out on something and really... What is your favorite types of foods? Like?
Whoa, her voice went way down there.
Who's that all of a sudden?
Frederick, what's your greatest regret in life?
Being out of the way. Not particularly a good thing at all.
No, no, it's not, Freddie.
We agree.
Anything else, Freddie?
Because I got every kid in there stepping around here.
She can talk some more?
No, that's all we have.
Oh, no, there's more.
Oh, you're kidding.
No.
Oh, I don't want to hear any more from her since she says she gave me. Oh, shut up.
What are you doing?
That nun song, Monique, whatever it was.
Dominique.
Yeah. It's a publicity scam. This was her moment. I mean, it was for her comeback to try to get a TV show.
It was her Arnold. She's such a female Arnold.
It's also the way as a comedian she does.
Female Arnold.
She warned us a few times, like, you're going to be in my stand-up. I was a little bit shocked sometimes.
I was a little bit shocked.
Is that it from her?
Yeah.
No. I'm sick of her.
Come on. I was nervous, I have to say.
Oh. Shut up.
Yeah.
Oh, me too.
All right.
Finally this morning, we have to end on a sad note.
Oh, no.
It's tears for the inventor of the laugh track. He died at age 93. His name was Charlie Douglas, and he invented the laugh box to increase the sound of an audience laughing or add laughter when there's no audience at all. He got the idea of making
a
laugh
machine.
Right. We will miss you, Charlie Douglas.
And that is the news.
That is the news.
Thank you, Shel.
Yeah.
Here's the dumbest thing we heard on the news today.
I'm not sure why this subject is as controversial as it is.
Mm-hmm. Move along, honey.
Yeah.
Just make out with a chick and shut up, okay? Quick time out. It'll be Chainsaw Sports. After this check on traffic, here's Route 66.
We're still backed up. North southbound Fox, Manzanitas Boulevard, Manchester. Got a wreck now. Southbound 15 at Miramar Road. Blocking the right lane and the off-ramp has traffic backed up to Mira Mesa Boulevard behind it. Gas prices are high, Hyundai prices are low, so hurry in now to your local San Diego Hyundai dealer. Get great savings on any 2003 model. I'm Ruth 66 with Dave Shelley and Chainsaw, 101.5 KGB.
101.5 KGB and the Fun Bike Center bring NASCAR to Cajon Speedway. Friday is the KGB Race of Champions, and it's going to be huge.
Marlin for the lead.
The NASCAR Winston Cup drivers, Sterling Marlin, Kenny Wallace, Ken Schrader, and Jimmy Spencer. Then they'll tear up the track and race each other on the fastest paved 3/8 mile in the West. Plus, promo battles Boyer for sidekick superiority in the celebrity race. The first 4,000 people through the gate get a free KGB Race of Champions t-shirt. Get your tickets now before they sell out at all San Diego Evanstar's locations. $20 in advance, 25 day of the race. The KGB Race of Champions. Nowhere else in San Diego can you see NASCAR drivers actually racing each other.
What a concept.
From the Fun Bike Center and San Diego's world-class rock.
101.5 KG.
People stop here, by here.
It's a Spring Thing sales event at Toyota of El Cajon, your number one truck superstore. New 2003 Tacomas, just $11,247 net cost. Five at this price, selling price is $11,997, minus a $750 factory rebate. New 2003 Tundras for $13,977 net cost. Five at this price, selling price is $15,477, minus a $1,500 factory rebate. New 2003 Camry LEs, $15,977 net cost. Five at this price, selling price is $16,977, minus a $1,000 factory rebate. It's the Spring Thing sales event, only at your locally owned and operated number one truck superstore, Toyota of El Cajon. Just off 8 East on El Cajon Boulevard in the city of El Cajon. Or call us at 1-800-EL-CAJON.
People who stop here, buy here, Toyota.
Rebates in lieu of any special financing.
The Cash Clock is brought to you by Nokia. Shop at Nokia.com/US to hook up with a new Nokia phone, service, and a cool downloadable ringtone.
Hello?
Hi, Rebecca. Sorry to bother you on the road.
No problem, Carl. I'm at the airport waiting for a flight.
Listen, I've got an important personnel decision I wanted to talk to you about.
Good is having the time for coworkers and friends.
My time is your time. What's up?
Better is getting free incoming calls from Nextel for $59.99 per month. So all the time you spend on those calls doesn't eat up your valuable cell minutes. You'll also receive unlimited night and weekend minutes, free nationwide long distance, and 400 outgoing anytime minutes. Plus, you get unlimited walkie-talkie minutes, so you can communicate instantly.
Yeah, thanks. I knew it would help to talk with you.
Oh, Carl, call anytime. I mean it.
To get free incoming calls, shop at Nextel.com or call 1-800-NEXTEL-9 for details. Find out how you can get $150 off select Nextel Internet-ready digital phones. Don't miss out. Shop at Nextel.com or call 1-800-NEXTEL-9. Offers end April 30th, 2003. One-year agreement, account setup fee, taxes, charges, and other restrictions may apply. Phones by Motorola.
Think about what it's like to drive a new Volvo S60 sports sedan. Think about rounding corners with a crisp sport-tuned suspension and turning heads with a sleek aerodynamic design. Think about some friends you'd like to have along for the ride. And now think about the unthinkable. A driver on a cell phone suddenly swerves into your lane. Think you'd appreciate 4-channel ABS and electronic brake distribution right about now? Or an available turbocharged engine that could quickly put that car ahead of you, behind you? We think you would. So test drive the Volvo S60. And in the meantime, watch out for those other drivers. Heaven only knows what they're thinking. The Volvo S60. Performance when you want it. A Volvo when you need it.
Lease a Volvo S60 for $299 a month for 36 months. Total amount to its signing, $3,714. On approved credit. Taxes, title, and tag fees extra. Customer liable for 20 cents a mile over 12,000 miles a year. Call 877-24-VOLVO for details. See your Southern California Volvo retailer today.
The Home Depot is more than a store. It's inspiration to create the lawn and garden wonderland you want. Right now, get everything you need to make your yard your pride and joy. The Home Depot has plants from all the best growers. Begonias to exotic orchids. Climbing vines to ground cover. We also have our one-year plant guarantee, so the color of your thumb will never come into play. Get the power to mow, blow, edge, and trim with the most dependable names in outdoor power tools. Powerful stuff like John Deere, Toro, Honda, and Echo. The right tools, the right accessories, the right one for you. And let our experienced associates answer all your questions to help you figure out what or how much you'll need to make your yard look spectacular. The Home Depot is the guaranteed low price every day to make every dollar work. We're more than a store. We're where your lawn and garden dreams become your lawn and garden reality. The Home Depot. You can do it. We can help.
Good morning, Jim. You're on a KGB. What's going on, bud?
Just giving you a little update on the weather out here in the beautiful Hamul.
It better be nice.
Well, once again, the golf gods are smiling upon the tournament.
Thank God.
And looking real good. And, hey, is Shelvis there?
Hello.
Shel.
Hey.
Does Dougie know how to play?
I've never played with him, but...
Douglas? Douglas knows how to play.
Hi, Douglas. You're such a person.
Doug, I think, is what he goes by.
Douglas.
Douglas. Wow.
We're teamed up with you today.
Oh, excellent. Do you know how to play?
Somewhat.
Oh, crap.
They're behind us.
No need to stay around for the banquet afterwards, huh?
We're going to do well. Anyway, weather's looking good.
Thanks, Jim.
See you guys out.
Thanks for the update. Appreciate that. Hamel will open today. Brought to you by Barona Valley Ranch Resort. Going out to Steel Canyon today to knock them out there. Looking forward to it. Raising some money for the Dave Schelling and Chainsaw Charities. I think this is our fourth straight year doing it at Steel Canyon now.
So.
Beautiful. Javier Sombrero Mexican Food's going to cater the event afterwards with some good grub. Looking forward to it. Going to be a beautiful day. All right, here's the Chainsaw with a sports update. A wrap-up for this morning here on the KGB. Good morning.
Well, good morning, and thank you very much, David. And hello again, everybody, in the sports world.
It's National Car Care Month, so get to AutoZone for a special deal on Castrol. Get in the zone. AutoZone.
$2.20 a gallon? If you're driving a gas guzzler, join the over 200 people who fixed that problem with us last month. Hi, I'm Mike Peterson, general manager of Tipton Honda. The EPA says Civics get 38 miles per gallon on the highway. We've created a $119 a month lease on Civic LXs. That's so low, you could make the payments with the money you'll save on gas. Now that's how you build a long-term relationship.
Tipton, we're in it for the long run.
On your approved credit, $2,600 cash or trade equity due from customer at lease signing. There's zero security deposit with 48 monthly payments of $119 plus sales tax. The lease includes 12,000 miles per year with 15 cents per mile over.
$119 a month and 38 miles per gallon. It's a good time for everyone to buy a Civic.
Tipton, we're in it for the long run.
Tipton Honda, right next to Home Depot and El Cajon.
Ask any picture in your photo album, and it'll tell you the Big Print Central at Ritz Camera was the best thing that ever happened to it. Go ahead. Leaf through the pages, and you'll know the minute you made the change to Big Print Central. All of a sudden, your photos are bigger, bolder, brighter, better. That's CSQ, camera store quality from real photo people. Ritz Camera features CSQ Crystal Image Big Prints and Digiprints. Just show us your frequent photo card and choose between two sets of Big Prints or a new roll of film for one low price. If you're of the digital persuasion, get camera store quality Digiprints in just minutes for as little as 39 cents each. They're better, faster, and cheaper than printing at home. And let's not forget the best way to save and archive your photos. That would be the Big E-Print CD. Just $6.99 with your frequent photo card, and it includes RitzPix Photo Director software to help you organize, email, and share your photos. A $30 value, free. Remember what it was like before Big Print Central? That's okay. Neither can anyone else. Capture your world at Ritz Camera.
Don't miss the Crossroads of the West Gun Show this weekend at the Del Mar Fairgrounds. You've heard about it. Now check it out.
Definitely the best show of the year, the Crossroads is. It's the largest show. It has the widest variety.
Crossroads of the West Gun Show this Saturday and Sunday. Del Mar Fairgrounds starting at 9 a.m. both days. Your ticket is good all weekend.
It's probably one of the biggest shows I've seen.
Almost 1,000 tables in two gigantic buildings featuring new and used guns, wholesale ammo, gun safes, reloading supplies, knives, hunting equipment, scopes, accessories, and more.
Got a lot of nice stuff down here.
It's huge. There's lots of tables. I guess there's over 1,000 tables.
Hunting guns, collector guns, military guns, handguns, rifles, shotguns, and police supplies. Some at wholesale prices. Books, jewelry, gift ideas, and door prizes every 2 hours.
There's no comparison.
Come on down.
This weekend, visit the Crossroads of the West Gun Show. This is the big one. Del Mar Fairgrounds. Take Interstate 5 to the Via de la Valle exit. All sales conducted in compliance with all federal, state, and local laws.
Save big on your Crossroads of the West Gun Show admission by logging on to 101KGB.com right now.
Now here's something you'll want to get your hands on. The best theme park value in Southern California. Better known as the SeaWorld Fun Card. Yes, it's back. And right now you can buy your 2003 card for the single day admission price and come back again and again and again for the rest of this year on up. Purchase before April 30th and you'll also get a bonus pack filled with great park savings and a special preview of our brand new 4D attraction, R.L. Stein's Haunted Lighthouse, coming in the spring. Of course, with all the exciting events at SeaWorld throughout the year, you'll want to get your fun card earlier and not miss a thing. In fact, why are you still listening to me? Oh, right. You got to hear this. Purchase your fun card at the park, at SeaWorld.com, or by calling 866-SHAMU-FUN. Wait. I still have to say, fun cards are valid through December 31st, 2003. Some blackout dates and other restrictions apply. Okay, you can go now. Hopefully you didn't hear that, because that would mean you're still listening and not heading to SeaWorld or calling the number I gave you or booting up your computer so you could log on.
Thanks for calling SBC Customer Service. May I help you?
Hi. If I order local service, can I add high-speed internet access, wireless service, or long distance?
Sure. You can add any service you like in any combination, and we'll only send one bill to your house.
How about a doghouse? Can I get the high-speed internet access, long-distance, local, and wireless services hooked up to a doghouse? It's about 3 by 5 feet, carpet, wood shingles.
Wow, you must really love that dog.
Well, actually, I'm living here now. My wife says it's just temporary, though. It'll blow over pretty soon, you know, probably. Back off, Fluffy, no!
Everyone has different needs, which is why with SBC you can get just the services you want, all together on one bill. To find the right combination of services and how you can save money, call 1-877-460-8015. SBC Pacific Bell is now simply SBC.
Fluffy! Fluffy, please! It's freezing out here!
For residential subscribers only. Long distance provided by SBC Long Distance.
Hi, this is Larry Hollingshead, General Sales Manager for Kearny Mesa Toyota. About 6 months ago, Kearny Mesa Toyota donated $10,000 to Operation Homefront. Here's what Operation Homefront Director Sandy Aldrich has to say.
Kearny Mesa Toyota's donation came at a critical time for us. Kearny Mesa Toyota came through for us when we needed them, and since then, donations have poured in, and as a result, we've been able to help hundreds of military families.
We owe a debt of gratitude to each of you in the Army, Air Force, Navy, and Marines. Oh, we thank you, every platoon and every crew. We do honor you for the courageous things you do. To our country, always true. To the red, white, and blue, we thank you.
Thank you from Kearny Mesa Toyota off 163 north of Balboa.
Dave, Shelley, and Chainsaw all morning. The Nutty Bunch. The Wacky Bunch. Those bastards.
Dave, Shelley, and Chainsaw. Those bastards. Only on 101.5 KGB.
All right, 888-570-1015, a direct connect. We got a lot of people want to talk. Brian, you're first up, buddy. You're on the air. Let's hear it.
I'm honored, Dave.
Good to have you with us.
I wanted to hear Boyer admit that when Chainsaw was talking about the National Hockey League and he referred to the Game 7, that Boyer was actually thinking, it's not Game 7, it's Game 7, like mothers-in-law or attorneys general. True or false, Boyer?
Frank. Yeah, go ahead, Chris. I got my ears on.
I don't know what this guy's saying.
Okay. Thank you, Brian.
Catch that.
But a valid correction.
All right, Chris, you're on the KGB. What's going on?
Oh, boy, I'm nervous. I'm on the nationally syndicated and internationally heard.
That's right.
Oh, man.
Oh, Chris. Pressure's on. Go ahead with your call.
I'm updating the world-famous SDR radio page, and question came to me is, will Boyer be at the Homu Open with a CB mic?
You want to field this one?
Frank.
Go ahead, Chris. I got your ears.
Chris, that'll be CB microphone like all of the equipment here in the studios will remain in the Crystal KGB studios.
That would be
I'm
no.
I'm not at risk taking it outside.
That's my incredibly elongated way. That's extended form, actually. What I'm saying is I'm going to take this amount of extra time to tell you no.
Oh, boy.
Thank you,
Chris. Thanks a lot.
See you, buddy.
Thanks, Chris.
Good morning, Frank. You're on the KGB. What's going on, bud?
Dave, you're crazy Dutch.
Dave.
Hey, wondering if Bromo's going to be wearing anything to the Hamul Open there.
Yes, he will.
He will? What's he going to be sporting?
He will be returning in last year's smash favorite, the hot pink hot pants,
yes,
complete with package compartment, and the tube top that says porn star on it.
I'd like to see a saran wrap tube top at some
point. Nice. Saran wrap tube top.
Maybe after a Bromo brain bowl or something. Maybe.
Shelly's actually got a great bet for me that I'm going to try and pull on a Bromwitz at my earliest convenience after this one.
I can't wait. We'll hope that happens.
Huh?
We'll be waiting for it.
All right, buddy.
Gotta go.
Are you going to be at the tournament today?
You know what? Work. Thinking about telling my boss to just take a hike.
Yeah.
Something nice. Not quite as nice that I can't say on the radio, but, you know.
I'm hip.
We'll figure it out.
All right. Well, there'll be pictures on the website, okay?
All right.
All righty.
Gotta go.
You're pretty good. Hey, Eric, you're on the KGB. What's up, buddy?
Hey, I'd like to report an announcer.
Oh, it's been a while. An acute spontaneous nasal reflux. Laughed it out his nose.
It was coffee all over the dashboard.
Oh, yeah. What caused it?
Yeah, it was during that West Hollywood lifestyle whatever thing.
Whatever.
Exactly. And then when Officer Tim went to go talk to him, he goes, oh,
that's part. That is a spoof, I guess, of a song called My United States of Whatever. The kids down the hall are playing it on their goddamn new wave radio station.
We hitched them up past our tits and we loved it.
Crazy hair. Can't understand a goddamn thing he said. She told me to mow the lawn. Yeah, I'm going to do it. All right, Dave, you're on the KGB. What's going on, buddy?
Dave, you know that all the cool Dave. Guys are named Dave, even us left-handed ones.
All right.
I got a couple of things here. I wanted to ask Chainsaw how long it takes to drive to Modesto normally, since he's from up in that area, if I remember correctly.
440 miles. Ooh. I'm looking at 7 hours straight.
Okay, because I'm going to Klamath Falls to see my brand-new grandbaby, first one I've had. Sweet.
Well, that's in Oregon, isn't it?
Yeah, actually it is, but Modesto's about halfway, so I figured I was trying to get about halfway to see if I could do it.
Nice place to stop. Garden spot. Yeah, sweet.
I think I'll turn right and go up the hill to the top of somewhere's up there.
Lodi.
What did they name your grandchild?
Her name is Heaven Backwards. Now, if you spell the word heaven
Nivea.
Backwards. I don't know. I just say hi, baby.
That's actually what they did. They took heaven, spelled it backwards, and gave her that name?
Yes, it is a name, and I can't even pronounce it.
I got to try.
H-A-V-E-N-N-E-A.
Navaya.
Yeah, I think it's Navaya. I don't know. It's my son. What do you expect? He's
the hippies.
They were in heaven.
Goddamn kids.
Also, Dave.
Yeah.
I know you're into golf, so I found this book that is The World of Golf, and it's got the history, the players, the tournaments, the classic courses. And I was wondering if you've ever heard of somebody called Great Triumvirate. Triumvirate.
Oh, yeah.
I don't know that.
It's a threesome from way back when in 1894, 1914.
No, I don't know this.
Anyhow, I was going to drop this book off, but I don't think I can make it before you get out of there today. So it will be there tomorrow, and I hope you enjoy it as much as I have, because I've learned more about golf in this book. It's really neat. It tells all the champions, everybody from the history of golf from the 13th century way back when. They're talking in some places, 1350, they had holes that were 1,000 yards long.
Nice!
And, the holes were on doors and a windmill and a kitchen and out.
Cool!
Anyhow, I will drop that off, and, you guys be good, you're always great, and you do know that it's true what they say.
All the cool guys are named?
Absolutely not. You are the best thing on the radio!
Thank you, Dave!
Have a safe trip,
Dave! Safe trip to Modesto. All right, John, you're next here on the KGB. What's going on, buddy?
Hey, how's it going, guys?
Tip-top.
Yeah, I was just wondering how Friday night was when you guys were interviewing Aerosmith and Kiss.
Oh, you mean on 84 radio stations coast to coast from Los Angeles to New York City?
Yeah,
Border to border.
Yeah, wasn't that international or something?
Yeah, it was.
Canada,
yeah.
Mexico.
Picked us up in Detroit.
Yeah, I was listening for a while. It sounded
shot
like
the program up into Canada.
Yeah.
It was cool. It was really cool to see how that network stuff works.
Yeah, but were those guys pretty cool to hang out with? Or?
They were very nice. They were very, very nice.
That's good.
Yep. Yeah, it was good. It was good to... It was a great experience. Really enjoyed it. And it's been a long time since I've been up to Los Angeles, and it was a beautiful day in L.A. that day.
Good. It really was.
Was it you and Shelley and Roberts, right?
Yes, Chainsaw. Cookie Chainsaw Roberts.
Yes.
Was with us. Yes, exactly.
You three, Blair wasn't there, though, was he? Or
no.
Romo?
Emily.
No.
Oh, Emily. Okay.
Emily went up there for us, pushed everyone around for us.
Yeah, you sound like you guys were having fun. So.
It was a good time. Thanks, John.
Cool. Yeah, no problem.
See you, bud. Listening up for that cash clock. When it winds down, we pay up to the tune of $100,000. When it winds down, just be the right caller to the toll-free national number.
I don't like national contests.
Then don't play, okay? Yeah. 866-525-WINS. $100,000, your shot with Diane Ring. In minutes, the KGB.
The Home Depot is more than a store. It's having someone you can count on to take care of the unexpected. Whether you need to replace a leaking roof or drafty window, or you want to update your siding, the Home Depot at-home services can have it installed for you. When you choose at-home services, you're tapping into a network of hand-picked professional contractors, experts who'll get the job done on time and on budget. And all the work is guaranteed by the Home Depot. The fact is, some things break, some things just get old. And sometimes you need a little help replacing them. For installation you can trust, count on at-home services. Right now, call 1-800-79-DEPOT for an in-home consultation. Plus, get a $100 Home Depot gift card free with the purchase of installed roofing, siding, or windows with at-home services. 1-800-79-DEPOT. The Home Depot. You can do it. We can help. Offer valid by mail-in rebate through April 30th with purchase of $2,000 or more. See rebate form for details.
Welcome to Nice Finish, brought to you by Michelob.
Monday morning.
Company you work for merges with multinational conglomerate. Stock prices double, then triple.
Noon.
Boss calls, wants to see you. Meet with boss, says company's downsizing. Suddenly you're what MBAs call redundant overhead.
That afternoon.
Pack office. Shake hands with everybody except receptionist. Receptionist gets hug.
On way to elevator.
Realize company policy no longer prohibits you from inner office dating. Turn around. Ask receptionist to grab beer. She says, definitely. Now that's a nice finish. What that deserves is a beer with a nice finish too. Whatever happens to you out there today, wrap it up with a cold, smooth Michelob.
Anheuser-Busch, St. Louis, Missouri.
With TVG, the interactive horse racing network, you can watch and bet on races from the nation's top tracks at home. Makes you wonder what else you can do from home, does it not?
Well, yes. I guess it does.
Let's see.
Hello, hot air balloons.
Hi there. Can I fly a hot air balloon?
Yes.
From home?
No, you'd have to come down for that.
Thank you kindly.
It's true. You can't fly a hot air balloon from home. But with TVG, you can watch the races and bet the races 7 days a week right from your couch. Sign up now at TVGnetwork.com or call 888-PLAY-TVG. Now, when you bet $50, TVG will give you $50. Log on to TVGnetwork.com or call 888-PLAY-TVG in time for the Kentucky Derby on May 3rd. Go to TVGnetwork.com or call 888-PLAY-TVG today. TVG, the interactive horse racing network. Watch TVG on Cox Digital Channel 329. Must be 21 or older and reside in a state where wagering services are available. Offer good for new accounts only. National Gambling Helpline, 1-800-233-8479.
Wounded Camp Pendleton Marines are home with their stories. And the Homeland Security Chief is in San Diego checking out this town and the border. Get the latest news 24 hours a day on News Radio 600 KOGO.
Driving on the 163 or the 805. Get off on down, boy, you'll be satisfied.
CNN's leasing Tahoe LSs for $359 a month. Drive a Tahoe for only $359 a month, plus tax for 60 months on approved credit. Get the most dependable, best-built, longest-lasting trucks on the road with air, CD, third-row seat, 12,000 miles per year, and 20 cents per mile over. There's zero security deposit, $1,000 cash or trade equity, plus the $3,000 factory rebate, totals to $4,000 due at lease signing. Through April 30th, get the Tahoe you've always dreamed of and a payment that's like a dream come true. $359 a month. In between the 163 and the 805 on Balboa in Kearney Mesa.
We're going to satisfy you, baby.
As the owner of a small business, you have a front burner and a back burner. Calming down a client who's irate over a billing mistake? Front burner. Figuring out how the Phoenix shipment ended up in Philadelphia? Front burner. But comparing long-distance plans? Definitely back burner. Unless there's a really good reason to upgrade it to front burner status, like there is now. Get 3.6 cents a minute when you switch to SBC Long Distance with a one-year term. Call now to lock in this incredibly low rate of 3.6 cents a minute and get the added bonus of consolidating your SBC local and long-distance business phone service to one bill. SBC Long Distance, now at the extra low rate of just 3.6 cents a minute. Seeing small business differently. Go to SBC.com or call 1-800-761-2020. Then put Long Distance right back on your back burner, where it belongs.
Limited time offer. This domestic direct billed service is provided by SBC Long Distance. $15 minimum monthly commitment required. Some plans must be direct billed. Taxes, fees, and any universal service funds extra. Offer excludes calling card calls.
Today's show has been brought to you by BMW of North America, Home Equity Mortgage, the Diamond Source, your Volvo dealers, the Escondido Cycle Center, Lexus dealers, and Toyota Carlsbad. Thank you, friends. All right, here's what we got going on today. It's the DSC Hamwell Open at Barona. Brought to you by Barona Valley Ranch and Casino. We're going to be at Steel Canyon this afternoon. Everybody who's playing is going to get the embroidered Hamwell Open golf shirt, and I haven't even seen it yet. Has anyone seen it?
Haven't seen it.
You get the shirt, you get the hat. That's courtesy of Ken and all the cool people at Marketing Works. You get the Dave Shelley and Chainsaw golf balls, tickets to the Stan Humphreys Golf Classic going next month at Morgan Run. After you're done setting the course record, Javier from Sombrero's Mexican Food is going to be catering your post-match dinner. There's Michelob Light in everybody's cart and a lot of great stuff, either in the silent auction or the raffle. A lot of great items from TaylorMade, O'Kelly, Aldila, Barbecues Galore. And we thank everyone who's donated their products or their services for the auction and the raffle, and especially all the people who put in their time. And to you for buying the Tee Times and hooking up with us. We got a little work to take care of, and then we're going to motor south to Hamwell. Get ready to do some playing. And yes, Abramowitz will be reprising.
Yay.
It's a show jacket. It
truly is.
We don't have a green jacket, but we do have pink hot pants.
Which is much better.
I agree.
Getting his face for it.
Hello?
Hey, Stubby, how's that
hair? Hey, buzz off! Two-face! Freak boy!
How's it finger?
Oh, shut, get pinned!
Hey, my cousin's coming to the hammer up, and you want me to take another shot at that, the other hand?
Ball. Shut up!
You know the one that you had covered?
Oh, shut the heck up!
Get you in the hand? That's pretty normal place for your hand, isn't it? You're always masticating on the course.
0 for 6 so far, boy. Way to go.
Are you excited about the hot
pants? No, I'm not excited about
hot
that
pants with a built-in package.
Damn it. Everybody else is.
It's freaking cold outside.
Aww. Is it?
Yeah, it is.
Big baby.
Yeah, we'll get to see your nipples,
baby.
Too.
I'm a big baby because I got to wear that thing, Ricky.
It's sunny out in Hamwell, though.
Oh, it's cold out there.
Just live out there. It's cold.
You were so affected by temperature.
Oh, pussy.
What's wrong with you? First you get sunburned if it's over 85 degrees, and then if it's below 70, you're freezing.
Okay, Mr. Race Shoes. I gotta have my race shoes, because you gotta feel the pedals. I get my race shoes on.
All they do is just make noises at each other anymore, have you noticed?
But it's so insulting. They're very vicious noises.
You better be on the other side of the golf course today, poop boy.
Why is that?
Why is that, Romo?
Because he's a kook and he bugs me out there. He'll be yelling me the whole time.
I'm sending my cousin out with his putter. He's going to take another shot at you, big guy. So get ready to have to learn to stroke it with your
feet. So get ready for
hilarity like this all day long.
Wow.
Aren't you glad you spent $630 bucks on that? All right, Bromo, see you out there.
Don't cry.
He's looking forward to it.
Hot pants.
Love it.
Diane Ray and Mojo Nixon coming your way next. We'll finish off the day at 7 o'clock, the Encore Show. Start it up fresh at 5 tomorrow. On the KGB San Diego. KGBB Temecula, love your show.
Crazy about his job.